High school football is back right here on WSBTV.com, presented by the Georgia Lottery. And tonight, it's the Bulldogs of North Gwinnett, ranked number 2 in the state, playing host to the Warriors of North Cobb. Hello, everybody, and thanks so much for joining us. Along with DJ Shockley, I'm Van Earl Wright, and we are thrilled to once again team up and bring you some of the best high school football in the country. And tonight, it's the Warriors coming off a season-opening loss, but they've got a great quarterback in Tyler Queen, DJ. Not only can he throw, but he's a run threat as well.
Absolutely. You think about Tyler Queen, you look at him, he's a big physical guy at almost 230 pounds. His size does a lot for this team. They're going to need his size and also his presence to be better than it was last week. He didn't have an ideal week by his standards, but he has to come out and play better if they want to get a win versus this very good North Gwinnett football team.
And his counterpart for the Bulldogs is John Urzua, his first year starting, and what a debut he made last week in the Corky Kell Classic, completing 79% of his passes.
Yeah, he came out and really exploded. He looked almost like a three-year starter how well he played, but he is a calm, cool, and collected guy, and you can see by the stats, he knows how to sling the football, and he could do that tonight. If he comes out and plays anywhere close to where he played last week, they're going to come out with another win.
North Gwinnett almost guarantees a great shootout.
Absolutely.
They definitely can guarantee a great show. It's a very exciting night right here at Tom Robinson Field in Sewanee, Georgia. Get ready because the kickoff is next on WSBTV.com. High school football is back right here on WSBTV.com. Thank you. Thank you. I can't see.
It's sun, right?
Moments away from kickoff, number 23 for North Gwinnett is Brad Harvey. He's a senior, first year kicking for the Bulldogs. Their kicker last year was All-State. He has a lot to live up to. Back deep, Drew Techman and Tajay Brawner. The kick is low and scoots into the end zone where it'll be whistled for a touchback. And North Cobb will start it off offensively. First and 10 from their own 25-yard line. And DJ, in our visit with North Cobb head coach Shane Queen, of course, the father of quarterback Tyler Queen, he said he was very disappointed in their performance last week and their loss to Northside Warner Robins. A lot of drop balls, yep, and just overall kind of sluggish.
Yeah, he spoke all the way around from offense to defense, didn't play well, and really didn't play well in the trenches, so that was a big issue. Obviously, he wants his quarterback, his son, Tyler, to play better, throwing only 9 for 30 with only, you know, he had 8 or 9 drops. But he wants this unit to play better, and he spoke earlier with us and said, hey, we had the best week of practice that we've had all year.
And that's what he was also commenting about his son, Tyler, saying after Monday's practice, after the disappointment of the season-opening loss. Shane Queen quoting his son saying, when they were driving home after Monday's practice, Dad, that was the best one we've had in years.
And hopefully that's a good thing for them. You know, you got to start with some high confidence. We asked him about the morale of the team, and he said the team was still pretty high, and they feel like they can beat anybody as we get started here.
Referees get it all situated, and here we go. First and 10 for the Warriors of North Cobb, and they start it off on the ground right up the middle.
As you would like, a good positive first yardage right there on first down, picking up 3-4 yards. And you see North Cobb instantly into this no huddle, trying to be up-tempo some.
Elijah Harrison, the ball carrier, on first down. Second and 6. Queen going to the air, looking for Harrison, swinging out of the backfield. Harrison kind of stumbled and could not make the completion, so it'll be 3rd and 6 for the Warriors of North Cobb.
That's simple pitch and catch there, Van Earl. They got to make plays like that and give themselves a chance here on third down. They still got a chance, but being 3rd and 6 is a little bit tougher than being maybe 3rd, 2, or 3.
3rd and 6 from their own 24-yard line. Shotgun snap for Tyler Queen. Feels the pressure and is complete to number 18, Andrew Lubbers, the junior receiver for North Cobb. And that's good enough for a first down as the sticks move down the field for the Warriors.
Nice job of throwing in the flat, finding his open receiver, not trying to be greedy. Getting out to a fast start, building confidence on offense is what this offense needs right now.
1st and 10 for North Cobb. Quick release and just too quick for Lubbers. He wasn't ready for that bullet delivered by Tyler Queen on the left side.
Two passes that should have been caught, and that's the reason why they had a tough night last week, was drop balls, drop passes on simple screens out to the flat. They got to make these type of catches or it's going to be another long night.
Our first minute of high school football on WSBTV.com has been documented. Three wide for the Warriors, left side. They pull it out of the belly of Harrison, and there goes Tyler Queen, the run threat that DJ told you about. Big gain down inside the 25-yard line of the Bulldogs of North Gwinnett. Great sleight of hand that time by the North Cobb quarterback, DJ.
And we talked about Bob Spire. We also talked about Coach Queen. He said the biggest thing they had to worry about was this guy on the move, being a runner, and he did that. Did a nice job of play action there, being able to take his hands and make a big gain out of it.
37-yard gain for the Warriors, and they are set up well and in good condition. 1st and 10 from the North Gwinnett 25. This time, the swing pass out on the left is a good one and complete to Lubbers. He's still fighting for yards, but he was running west and east instead of north and south and only picked up a couple.
Yeah, eventually he's got to get north and south. It's a good job of making guys miss, but eventually you got to get upfield, pick up the first down, but he's just trying to make a play there, Van Earl. You can't excuse the guy all the time.
2nd and 1 for the Warriors of North Cobb. First drive of the game from the 16-yard line of North Gwinnett. Hairston almost took the snap. Queen had to battle him for it. That was a miscommunication in the backfield of North Cobb and a loss of yards.
Well, the issue with that is simply they got too much penetration up front. And that caused a lot of issues for North Cobb in the backfield. So whatever that happens, it's going to be an issue in the backfield. It's a good job of just getting back possibly to the line of scrimmage.
Loss of 4, so it'll be 3rd and 5 for Queen and the Warriors from the 20-yard line. Queen not ready for that snap. He fumbles it. North Gwinnett trying to pounce on him. He's trying to throw the ball away. A dangerous play by Queen and another miscommunication by the Warrior offense.
Oh, man, that's just a bad thing right there. You see Coach Queen is always out to the numbers yelling at his players. Big-time situation here on 4th down. They had a chance to capitalize. Will they go for it? And a replay, you see it. He has it out to the side. Maybe he wasn't ready. Doesn't like he was ready. The offense wasn't ready for it, at least.
The center is Michael Reyes, number 69. He's a junior, and it looks like 2 bad snaps that he did not get the clear signal from quarterback Tyler Queen. So it'll be 4th and 5 for the Warriors. They were looking good, and now the last 2 plays, they have not looked so good. They're going for it on 4th and 5. Good pass rush by North Gwinnett. Queen trying to get rid of it as he's taken down. But Mitch Hyatt and number 24 and Avery Elford in on the pass rush, as well as Matthew Adriski, a junior for the Bulldogs, will force the Warriors into turning the ball over on downs, so their drive stalls in North Gwinnett territory. After a pretty good drive and a great gain on a 37-yard run by their quarterback, Tyler Queen.
Man, you just said something real interesting. On the sack was Mitch Hyatt, the All-American tackle. That just doesn't happen most of the time when you see a guy getting a sack.
Now, here we go with the crazy offensive show. And look at that. They fumble on the first play, does North Gwinnett. Quarterback John Urzua and Jordan Fry, they had a miscommunication in the backfield that time.
Yeah, it's been documented about John having a fabulous week in his first time starting. Senior first time starting, 38 of 48 last week, almost 498 yards with seven touchdowns.
Amazing performance. Urzua taking a clean shotgun snap that time, looking right, throwing into double coverage, but complete to Kyler Knutson, who also had a fantastic game last week in their thrilling victory against Merkitchen when he caught eight balls for 140 yards.
Yeah, it's one thing they're going to have to be able to get to John Urzua. They can't let him sit back there all night and complete passes to all his guys and have another big completion night.
Gain of four, so it's third and six for the Bulldogs. Urzua over the middle, caught, complete to number 15. Amator Bebe. His first name is Daniel. He's the senior of the two Amator Bebe brothers. Josh is the junior. He wears number 80. The older brother wears number 15.
Yeah, that's going to be a name we're going to say all night long. Both these guys catch a lot of passes and are very intricate in his offense.
First and 10 for the Bulldogs. Less than 8:45 to go here in the first quarter. Just underway with high school football. Urzua pulls it out of the belly of the running back, keeps it himself, gets it across midfield, close to the 45-yard line of North Cobb.
John telling Tyler Queen, take some of that. I got some of that in me as well. John not known for his running ability. You see the replay here, pulling it and getting north and south, getting a lot of yards, picking up another first down. Good job of him up front, also his offensive line.
First and 10 from the North Cobb 47-yard line for Urzua and the Bulldogs. Little audible from the sideline. Urzua passes along the communications to his offense. Number five in the backfield with him is Cameron Pickett. Urzua again looking to throw, and he's got Almanzo Brown, but it might be a loss of a yard or two. Good coverage that time by number 40 and number 21 and 20 of North Cobb.
Yeah, nice job of Rashawn DeCastro actually getting out there to make a play. It's an outstanding job of him running to the football. You see number nine right there, Brandon Bennett, also making a play on the perimeter, keeping up from any kind of big play.
So a loss of two resulting in second and 12 for North Gwinnett. Up the middle to the running back, Cameron Pickett, the 5'9", 200-pound junior.
I expect them to go to the air now. This is a situation where they want to throw the football. John's been pretty good at being accurate with it. Expect him to go to the air with this one.
Third and eight for North Gwinnett. Clean shotgun snap, pass rush. Almanzo Brown coming back to help out his quarterback, but he can barely get it back to the line of scrimmage. So it will result in a fourth down situation for Bob's Fire and the Bulldogs of North Gwinnett.
That's a pretty good job right there of tackling open field, but John May doing his pooch punt here. But good job of tackling open field, and North Cobb bringing some pressure.
Urzua set up a little deeper than normal. Now he steps back up into his normal quarterback position. Expect a quick kick here from the North Gwinnett quarterback. Instead, he's going for it. Plenty of time to throw. Going down the right side. Looking for Almanzo Brown, and a flag comes out. It could be pass interference against Terrain St. Romain of North Cobb. We'll wait and see what the call is.
I think it will be. He never even turned around to look for the football. He got to turn around and give himself a chance. You see on the replay, he turns around late, but it's too much jostling and pushing on the outside by Terrain St. Romain.
So that time, Bob's Fire passing on the quick kick, which he employed a couple of three times last week in their thrilling win over McEachern. This time, he pressures the North Cobb secondary into a pass interference, and it's first and 10 from the 31-yard line for the Bulldogs. Keeping it on the ground this time to Jordan Weddington up the middle. He's a senior running back, 6 foot, 195 pounds. He carried the football eight times last week for 55 yards.
Nice job of him keeping his balance. Nice, strong run. That's a guy who's hungry and wants to get more carries.
Picked up six on that play, second and four. just under 6 minutes to go here in the first period. Handed it to the scat back, running it up the middle. Gain of a couple of 3 yards. That's Jordan Fry, number 27, carrying the football for the Bulldogs.
You know, Banjo, a little bit different game plan this week. Last week, we talked about John throwing it 48 times. They're on the ground this week, rushing it, trying to get the ground game going.
Throwing off the North Cobb defense. You got to believe they were preparing for a lot of aerial attack. Ninth or 10th play of the drive now for the Bulldogs. Urzua showing ground, pulling it back, and now he's going to take it himself. Good cut inside, but also a good shoestring tackle that time by number 45, Cale Reed, the junior inside linebacker for the Warriors.
I think that's where the maturity of John Urzua showed up right there. He looked down the field, wanted to throw it deep, didn't have it, pulled it down, got some positive yardage out of the play.
Good decision, 5 yard gain. A positive play, as you said, DJ. North Gwinnett on the move as we hit the 5 minute mark of the first period. Back to Weddington, reverses field and gets it inside the 10 yard line down to about the 8 yard line. Effective offense, very effective offense for the Bulldogs.
Yeah, you gotta look at the block right there by number 67, DJ Jordan. That's just an great offensive blocking formula right there going off behind him.
First and goal to go for the Bulldogs, and timeout is called on the field. Timeout, North Cobb. Their defense needs a breather.
Yeah.
Against this no-huddle, up-tempo offense from the Bulldogs.
Well, they're running down their throat right now. A couple passes here and there. Had the big pass on fourth down that it caused a big pass interference, but that's a nice job of running the football right here by North Gwinnett. North Cobb doing an outstanding job as well of trying to withstand the big plays right now. We know North Gwinnett can have the big plays, but North Cobb is withstanding that right now.
I tell you, it's amazing how the defenses, with all of this up-tempo offense that is the craze right now, DJ, they just can never seem to keep up, and that's why everybody is adopting it.
Yeah, I mean, it works pretty well. Keeps defenses off balance, keeps that same defensive package on the field, so you're allowed to do a lot of different things out of different formations.
First and goal to go for the Bulldogs from the 9 yard line. Here comes the 12th play of their opening drive of the game. Poor throw from Urzua. It hit the ground. It was intended for Daniel Amator Bebe.
One of the bad passes you've seen right here from John. You don't see many of these. I think he might have rushed it a little bit. He kind of got a little antsy. He saw the zone there, but this doesn't look like a guy who would be antsy after throwing 7 touchdowns last week.
And throwing the ball 48 times in the game.
Right.
Sheesh. That was just amazing. He threw it 48 times.
That's a lot.
Completed 38 and finished with 498 yards a week ago. Urzua, plenty of protection, rolling to his right, throwing and picked off in the end zone by number 23, and he's going to bring it out. He should have just taken a knee, and he could have had it out to the 20, but number 23, Gilbert Blow for the Warriors, coming up with a huge play to deny the Bulldogs, and they were knocking on the door.
Yeah, I'm sure they probably wish you to take that knee, but I think they'd take him taking that interception as well. This is just John right here being a little greedy, trying to force a ball in there. Not a good idea when you at least got 3 in the red zone. That's one thing he didn't do last week was throw interceptions. He only had 1. He has to take care of the football, especially in the red zone.
So Gilbert Blow makes a great play to deny the Bulldogs of the end zone. He probably wishes he would have taken a knee in the end zone because now his offense has to start 1st and 10 from their own 4 yard line. They're keeping it on the ground. Up the middle to number 3. Tajay Bronner gets it across midfield. Wow, what a huge hole up the middle for the Warriors. Just what they needed, a gain of 47 yards.
Well, that just worked very well for them. You're just talking about being in the shadow of their own end zone. Big run, big play. North Cobb's right back up at them right now.
1st and 10 from the North Gwinnett 49-yard line. Fantastic play for the Warriors. Exactly what they needed at that time. keeping it on the ground yet again. Number 31, Elijah Harrison, a 5'10", 185-pound sophomore.
Not much running there. Good job of North Gwinnett trying to capitalize on a big run there. North Cobb not able to wreak havoc on that one. So they're back here on second down.
Looks like it'll be second and 10. No gain on the play. Play action. Ooh, that defender hit him, hit the receiver a little too
yeah,
soon.
Yeah, you caught
like
it.
To me.
And you saw that. The flag's out there.
The flag comes out.
You called that one before the flag came out. That looked a little early. You see on the replay here. He goes right through his back. He's almost a half a second too early. Got to get that call every time.
Pass was intended for DJ Render, but Ollie Edwards, the senior, guilty of pass interference. So it'll be automatic first down and a mark-off of 15 yards with that pass interference penalty against the Bulldogs, resulting in a first and 10 from the North Gwinnett 34-yard line for the visitors from North Cobb.
A few short minutes ago, they were backed up in their own shadow. Now they're already in North Gwinnett territory.
Inside the 35-yard line. Tyler Queen looking for a running back. Tajay Brawner, another miscommunication in the offensive backfield for the Warriors.
Not what they wanted. I mean, they had the big run. Now they're in second down. They long again, lose a couple yards. You got to win the first down battle.
Second and 11, a loss of one. This is the kind of stuff you're supposed to work through in the preseason
scrimmages.
Not in the second game of the year. Second and 11, Queen show and throw right from the get-go. Over the middle, intended for Billy Nichols, but Queen off the mark, or maybe Nichols stopped running, not really sure who was the guilty party.
Yeah, it's tough to tell if you know who's, you know who's intended for. You don't know if he's supposed to keep on the move or sit it down. That just comes with off-season work, and we talked about Tyler Queen actually missing some off-season work because of an elbow injury. So maybe the timing is a little different and off with his receivers.
And he's also got four or five receivers that he's really playing with for the first time. This time, Queen takes it up the middle. The big 230-pound quarterback bulldozes his way down close to the 30-yard line. They'll mark it at the 27-yard line.
This is Tyler using that big body. We talked about it in the open. He has to use his size to wheel his offense to make plays. And he did that on that play, brings up a big fourth down.
Here comes the eighth play of the drive. Fourth down for the Warriors. Fourth and three from the 27-yard line. Queen looking left, going down the left sideline, and caught. Caught by number four, Lloyd Jones, the 5'9" senior. Leaped and reached out and snagged that delivery from Tyler.
I know, that's called wanting more than the defender. The defender is standing there waiting for the football. Austin, he has to just go and attack the football. Austin Kim on the outside, he has to go and attack that football instead of waiting for it to come. And that's why he was able to come down with it. Good job by Lloyd Jones.
Beautiful fourth down conversion for the Warriors, and now they're inside the 10, first and goal to go. Tyler Queen using his size and his forward lean to get it down close to the 6-yard line.
Yeah, we keep talking about his size because that's the reason why he's getting extra yards, because he's able to fall forward, 230 pounds. He's probably just the same size as most of those North Gwinnett linebackers.
Second and goal to go from the 6-yard line for the Warriors. Queen moving to his right, feeling pressure, throwing it to the goal line, intended for number 12, Jordan McCray. That's his favorite target. Only caught two balls a week ago, but one of them was for a touchdown.
Here's something I got to say. I want to see more out of Tyler. He has to have a sense of urgency, especially on those rollouts. He's kind of just going a little slow, and the defense coming on. He has to take a sense of urgency and get to the corner. He has to be a threat to run the football just as much as throw it.
Now third and goal from the 6-yard line. 11th play of this drive for the Warriors. Over the middle and caught. Touchdown, North Cobb, as the visitors get on the scoreboard first. Caught by Jordan McCray, the senior receiver for the Warriors.
And you got to think about where the drive started, Van Earl, and what it started from. The interception from the defense, and they're taking it the full distance of the field. That's called capitalizing on a turnover. Great job of North Cobb at that point.
10-play, 96-yard drive, and the PAT is up and no good. So only a 6-0 lead. Will Horton, the junior kicker, off the mark.
And here's the replay. Nice, easy, catchable pass. Look at that. Good route on the outside by his receiver, Jordan McCray. Another big touchdown catch for him. Just talked about him only having 2 catches last week. Nice job.
Just underway here, approaching the end of the first quarter. Less than 2 minutes to go. You're watching Heist Friday Night Football in the Sports Zone on WSBTV.com, presented by the Georgia Lottery. Back at Tom Robinson Field at North Gwinnett High School, where the visitors have jumped out on top. A 10-play, 96-yard drive after an interception finished off by Tyler Queen to Jordan McCray, and they lead it 6-0 after the failed PAT. Will Horton kicks it down to the 20-yard line, and a fair catch signaled by number 25 of North Gwinnett. That's Brian Everhart.
I'm looking forward to seeing what his offense can do. I'm gonna see how John Azua responds after throwing a big interception. This is probably the first time he's had some real big time adversity after a bad play. Last week, everything went pretty good. It was just a seesaw battle back and forth. But now is the big time how he responds as a senior after throwing a big time interception.
And he is a senior, but it's his first year as the starting quarterback. North Gwinnett's QB a year ago was the coach's son, Hayden's Fire. First and 10 for the Bulldogs from their own 20. They stick to the ground and hand it off to Cameron Pickett, who goes right side and makes a good gain, getting it out to the 25-yard line, it looks like.
Looks like they want to get some start.
But we got a flag.
Got a penalty way over.
Our referee tonight is Mike Boyd. Fast and furious first quarter, though.
Yeah, it has.
And looks like it's going to go against the offense as they move it back to about the 11-yard line. Holding against the Bulldogs.
That's not how you want to start a drive out. Now you're back in your own territory, way back, hard to overcome these penalties.
First and 20 now for the Bulldogs. Urzua going left side, laying out was number 13. Harold Johnson could not come up with the catch.
Yeah, that's the only thing that it puts you in a bad situation once you get that big holding penalty. Now you're so far behind, it's hard to come back from penalties like this, but we know North Gwinnett, they're going to try to throw their way out of it.
Second and 20 from their own 11-yard line. Urzua looking right, going for the short check down receiver. Complete to number 30, Jordan Weddington.
Small game. Right now it's all about getting some completion, getting some yardage, but not many plays you can call right here for third and 15, Van Earl.
A gain of just 5 yards on the play. As DJ said, it'll be third and 15. Urzua looking over for instructions from the sideline. The offensive coordinator, Trey Moore, calls the game from up top here at the press box. Zua showing play action, drawing the rush, a little screen, complete to number 30, Jordan Weddington, breaking a couple of tackles, getting it out beyond the 25-yard line, but still short of the first down.
Yeah, they needed 15 and got 13, so not enough. Hard to overcome that, so like the punt's going to come onto the field. You let you get on 30 long, screen or draw. Good effort, but even better job of North Cobb holding them to only not those three and out.
The punter for the Bulldogs is the guy who also handles the place kicking duties, number 23, Brad Harvey. 5'11", 200 pounds. And a fake punt. I'm not surprised coming from Bob's Fire. They snap it to the up man, number 12, Matthew Andruski, and he picks up the first down, and how could we even attempt to be surprised?
Come on, this is a team that's known for the hook and ladders and all the trick plays. You know Coach has those deep in his pockets and ready to go, but great job. This may be the kickstart they need. There's Coach Spire, as you can see right there. Great job, my man Nathan, on the ground getting some coverage of Coach Spire.
And we have reached the end of the first quarter. Fast and furious action, just coming off a successful fake punt, but it's North Cobb who has the lone score of the game. They lead it 6-0. You're watching Georgia High School football from the Sports Zone on WSBTV.com, presented by the Georgia Lottery. Thank you so much for joining us on this first night of Friday Night Football from the Sports Zone, along with DJ Shockley. I'm Van Earl Wright and our entire hard-working crew. We are at Tom Robinson Field at North Gwinnett High School, where the home team has the football, about to start the seventh play of their current drive from their own 37-yard line. Little screen play.
Wow.
But incomplete, intended for Jordan Fry.
If John had a half a more second to set that screen up, this game would be tied up. They had to set up perfect call. North Cobb comes with an all-out blitz. They get to John Ozua before he gets the ball out. So, hey, good call by North Cobb.
Incomplete, so it's second and 10 from their own 38. Play action, complete. Over to number 7, that's Josh Amator Bebe.
It's a good job of getting his hands out in front, making an easy completion there for North Gwinnett. That's a good job.
Gain of 13 yards and across midfield to the North Cobb 49-yard line. Bulldogs keep it on the ground this time, modest gain for Jordan Fry. Down the left side. We haven't even talked about the best offensive lineman, arguably, in the entire state of Georgia and one of the top 10 offensive linemen in the country, number 75 for North Gwinnett. He's at left tackle. His name is Mitch Hyatt. The only time we mentioned him is when he had a pass rush playing defense. Urzua, quick release, caught. Number 11 is off and running. That's KJ Hancock. Oh, and a touchdown saving tackle by Devon Harris of the Warriors of North Cobb, but a big play for the Bulldogs, a gain of 29.
Nice job of KJ getting the ball over the field, making one guy miss, and that's what happens when you make a guy miss. You got a chance to go to the house with it, and this is what North Gwinnett prepares. This is what they look for, is big plays.
some long drives in this game. Here comes the 10th play of this current drive. Back to Cameron Pickett, looking for some blocks. Gets it inside the 10.
Now you see they're doing a lot of run to the left side. You just mentioned All-American Mitch Hyde over there on the left side, who's going to be looking forward to watching the game on Saturday when they play the Georgia Bulldogs, play the Clemson Tigers, because he's committed to Clemson, so he's going to be watching that one really good.
You mean the Clemens?
The Clemens. Yeah. I know you like the Clemens, just South Carolina guys, so I know you're pretty
down
right now.
Yeah, I walked myself right into that.
You did. We'll talk more about that in a second.
Second and goal from the 6-yard line. Cameron Pickett with the football, going for the corner, fighting. Stopped short, according to the linesman. Stopped at the 1-yard line, or maybe the half-yard line.
So close, and they're going to run this football in. I mean, they got to keep giving it to him. Cameron's been the workhorse, especially running the football as they got down in the red zone. Expect Cameron to get the ball one more time, let him feed it, and let him have the reward of it.
First and goal from the half-yard line. Dork Gwinnett knocking on the door for a second time in this contest. High snap, but they give it to Pickett, and he leaps over and gets it into the end zone for the first touchdown of the night for the Bulldogs of North Gwinnett.
You got to reward the horse that got you there. Good running, good blocking up front. Half a yard, your offensive line has to win that battle, and they did.
On to attempt the point after. Number 23, Brad Harvey. His holder is number 14, Andy Summers. The snapper, Mitchell Gladstein. Good snap, good hold, and a good kick. So North Gwinnett, thanks to the PAT from Harvey, takes the lead, but by just 1 point. The Bulldogs are up on the Warriors 7-6 as we approach the 10-minute mark. Friday Night Football from the Channel 2 Sports Zone on WSBTV.com, presented by the Georgia Lottery. Brad Harvey about to kick it away for the Bulldogs. Warriors have two men deep standing inside their own 5-yard line. Harvey gets it away. Good long kick.
Wow.
All the way through the back of the end zone. Touchback.
That's a leg.
That is a big leg.
That is a leg.
I was talking with the kid before the game, Brad Harvey, his first year kicking, and he said he went to some summer.
First year ever kicking?
Went to some summer place kicking camps, and longest one he converted was 57 yards.
That's it? Only 57, huh?
He ended about 65 yards on that kickoff.
Right.
So North Cobb takes over their third drive of the game, I believe. They will have it first and 10 from their own 20-yard line after the touchback. Queen gets pressured but finds a halfback right over the middle. Number 5, Bryce Perryman.
I had the screen set up, tried to come out with a screen on first down, which is a pretty good call, not expecting it. North Gwinnett was sitting there ready and waiting for it. You see, maybe the temperatures changed a little bit for North Gwinnett after that fake punt.
Perryman continues to hang out in the backfield with his quarterback, Queen. And Queen hands it off to Perryman right side, but good pursuit by the Bulldog defense and tracked down by Desmond Fields and Austin Kim.
Nice, hard, tough run there, trying to get the corner. You end up getting the corner and getting enough for the first down. I like the way Perryman runs. He gets upfield and then puts his head down and gets as much as he can.
Still managed to pick up the first down, so it'll be first and 10 from their own 31-yard line for the Warriors. Less than 9.5 to go in the first half. A one-point ball game in favor of the home team. Queen complete to number 18, Andrew Lovers, but he went the wrong way, and then he put the pig on the floor. But the whistle, the play was blown dead before he lost the handle.
How many times have we said this already, Van Earl? They're going a lot of east and west running.
Right.
This is a fast North Gwinnett defense. They look and they just love you going east and west. You going north and south, that's a little bit harder. East and west, they're going to run you down.
So the loss on the play results in a second and 16 for the Warriors. And a whistle blows the play dead. Illegal procedure against the Warriors that'll back them up 5 more yards, so it'll be second and 21. Going the wrong way is the team in white.
Absolutely. Not much wrong on this. We talked about North Gwinnett when they had the penalties starting out on first down. It's hard to overcome these long penalties that put you behind the chains.
Quarterback for the Warriors in white, Tyler Queen, the head coach's son, swings it out to his left side. Completes it to Lubbers, but again, a modest gain and another flag on the play.
Interesting to see what this flag is possibly holding on the outside. That might back him up even more.
You got it. There it is. Declined by Bob Spire. So it'll be third and long. The last play was second down. They declined the penalty, so I'm, yes. It'll
there
be third
go.
Down.
You know the game, Van Earl.
Thank you, DJ. Third and 20 for the Warriors. Queen taking a couple of steps to drop back. Being harassed, chased out of the pocket, looking downfield. He's got a man, caught, complete, right at the sideline in front of the North Cobb bench is Billy Nichols. Huge gain for the Warriors and a great play, improving, but another flag comes out on the field.
And this comes back, this takes away from a highlight reel play for Tyler Queen.
Ineligible man downfield on the offense, so that big gain that was enough for a first down is wiped off the board.
That's a tough call right there. That's tough. I don't know if Tyler maybe crossed the line of scrimmage or not, but that was a heck of a play by him.
When your quarterback scrambles, sometimes the linemen step across the line of scrimmage. You think Queen was across the line?
It's a possibility. He got close to that line. He ran up in there. I'm not sure if that's what they call, but he was close to the line. But other than that, it was a great play. You can see why Auburn is excited to have him coming there next year.
Timeout on the field right now with 8:17 to go and a third and 19 for the Warriors of North Cobb. And you're talking about Tyler Queen already committed to Auburn before his junior year, and then in his junior year, he went out and helped this high school club make it to the semifinals of the Class 6A playoffs.
Yeah, he's, you know, we talked to Coach Queen about having him on his team and coaching his son, and he talked about it's going to be a tough moment to see him leave because he's been around, he's been part of the first playoff win that they had together. And Tyler's done a great job for not only his team but for this program, and he's kind of put him on the map. So once he leaves this season, it's going to be tough to replace a guy like him.
Well, we got three of those situations tonight because Bob Spire was in the same situation with his son Hayden last year, and you, when you were in high school, you were playing for your dad.
Absolutely. It's a It can be fun. It can also be bad at times, too. Pops,
I bet.
Pops get on you a little bit. You know, he don't want to show any favoritism, so he works you a little bit harder. But at the end of the day, it's a good relationship. You get to go home and watch film and learn everything you can from the head guy who's calling the play. So he knows exactly what Tyler's thinking, and he knows exactly what his dad wants done on the field.
But sometimes some light conversation at the dinner table.
Light, yeah.
After some not-so-glamorous practices. Here we go with 3rd and 19 for North Cobb from the 24-yard line. Over the middle, Tyler Queen caught complete to number 30. Quaddy Green across the middle. That is close to the first down. They mark it at the 40, so they're a yard shy. Wow. And they might go for it on 4th and 1.
3rd and 24, Northwood that gives up 23. That's a nice play drawn up right there, playing in zone coverage. And oh yeah, they're going for it.
From their own 40-yard line, 4th and 1 for North Cobb.
What do you think's coming? He's under center. What do you think's happening? 230 pounds.
Exactly. He's just gonna lean forward. Oh, but big, oh, that's close.
Oh, the second effort.
He went on the right side behind Zach Winstead and Jordan Smith. But the North Gwinnett defense made him fight for it. Just depends on the mark right now. They needed to get to the 41. They might be at the 40 and a half. I think they've marked it short.
Ooh, this could
be the first down. Timeout on the field as Mike Boyd asked for a measurement.
Instead of Tyler just taking it and going, he kind of went a little bit to the right and tried to see what's
going
on.
More east-west.
More east-west.
Go north-south, baby.
This is half a yard. You can see him over there. Him and his dad are going at it. About he should have went north and south. See, that's that confrontation right there. That's the kind of stuff me and my dad went through right there. They say, hey, son, half a yard, we need it. And he didn't get it.
And he did not get it, and North Gwinnett will take over. As the Warriors come up short on 4th and 1, and the Bulldogs take over 1st and 10 from the 41-yard line of North Cobb. 7.5 minutes to go here in the first half. The Bulldogs looking to build on their 1-point lead. North Cobb has shown plenty of flashes of very good football, but in crunch situations, they've come up a little short.
Yeah, and North Gwinnett's brought a new quarterback in, actually.
New quarterback for North Gwinnett. Allende Russell, a wild play as they throw it to Knutson and then back across the field to Russell, and he's going for the end zone. Here comes the bag of tricks from North Gwinnett head coach Bob Spire. I love watching this Bulldog team play because Bob Spire knows how to make it entertaining.
That's the type of play you call coming out of a turnover or a loss of down. Bob Spire never disappoints you in the trick play category.
He's unbelievable. Look at Spire down on the field.
Oh, yeah. You would think he had a penalty right there. He is an excitable guy.
And when we asked him about it this week, he kind of chuckled on the phone and said, yeah, I got a few plays in that bag of tricks. Last week, he pulled off a hook and ladder. We covered a game last year right here at Tom Robinson Field.
Oh, wow. What a game that was.
Where he pulled off a hook and ladder as his team rallied from 20 down with 4-plus minutes to go and won the game. And now they're going for 2. Urzua back under center to Weddington, fighting for the end zone. He's in there, and North Gwinnett will make it a 15-6 ball game. 7:25 to go in the first half. North Gwinnett increases their lead from 1-9. You're watching Friday Night Football from the Channel 2 Sports Zone on WSBTV.com, presented by the Georgia Lottery. I missed the play. Do we have it on replay?
He threw it.
Did he take the snap?
He took the snap, threw it to his receiver.
Knutson.
And his receiver threw it back to him, and he had all the linemen over there waiting on him.
All right. So they've run the fake punt. Did they do another trick play?
Who?
North Gwinnett?
That was a trick play.
I know, that one. And so a week ago, North Gwinnett head coach Bob Spire reached into his bag of tricks and called for the hook and ladder that resulted in a touchdown. Earlier in this game, a fake punt that resulted in a first down. And now his Bulldogs lead 15-6 after a play that can be called, help me out, DJ, throwback, a flea flicker?
Throwback to the quarterback.
Okay.
That's what that was.
Here goes Harvey with the kickoff. Fielded in the end zone. That's an automatic touchback in high school football. So North Cobb will take over first and 10 from their own 20. Here was the touchdown play.
Very interesting play. He takes the center, throws it to receiver, he throws it back. Now look at the convoy. 1, 2, 3, 4, all five linemen are leading the way. Look at that. He got nobody even touches him all the way to the end zone. He's just kicking him out. A nice job of getting the end zone and getting the score.
That's Allende Russell, the backup quarterback, also a senior. And he scores his first touchdown of 2014. North Cobb about to start their fourth drive of the game. Queen harassed, but complete to number 21 out of the backfield. C.J. Cole.
Another penalty on the outside.
Man.
This goes backwards. This can't be good if it's for North Cobb.
Face mask this time. But this time it's against North Gwinnett. So the line of scrimmage will be the 34-yard line of the Warriors. First and 10 for Tyler Queen and North Cobb. Keeping it on the ground. Up the middle to Tajay Brawner. 5'8", 170-pound senior for the Warriors.
At least it's a positive play going forward. North Cobb's trying to get something going before this half ends. Almost 6 minutes to go, but they need more on this offense.
Again, up the middle to Brawner, fighting for yards and hit hard and taken down by number 22, Connor Cleed, the safety for the Bulldogs after a gain of 8 yards on the play. Good enough for another Warrior first down. Line of scrimmage at midfield.
Fast-paced offense is working right now for North Cobb. Got North Gwinnett a little bit off balance.
Queen, left side, complete to Quani Green, and a loss of one. Good play by number 56, Aaron Hart, one of the five linebackers in the Bulldog 3-5-3 defense.
These guys got to get more north and south. Quani Green again going east and west. Nothing positive going from east and west.
Loss of one on the play. It'll be second and 11. Oh, big play, big penetration by number 59, Michael Germano, a junior for the Bulldogs.
Nice job of Mike.
Big loss.
Nice job of Mike getting that penetration and wrapping him up like he had those big claws on him. There's no way he was getting out of that bear hug.
5'10", 225 pounds. Is number 59. Queen continuing to work out of the shotgun. And another flag comes out. Going to be offside on the defense.
Gotta help with this third down. They'll need that. Third and 11 or 12. Tough to manage. Third and 7 or 8 is a little bit better.
Third and 7 it will be for the Warriors. They are now in Bulldog territory. Queen over the middle and not caught. stripped. It was caught for a half a second, but not long enough by number 12, McCray. Great defensive play made by the defender.
And you can see the big-time arm that Tyler Queen has. This is a 20, 25-yard rope by Tyler Queen. Hit it right in his chest. He's got to make this catch. Look at this. Look at this. Look at this ball. Stand in the pocket, deliver a strike. That ball hits him in the chest. He takes one step.
Jay Stackhouse stripping him of the football. Great defensive play, but McCray has got to tuck away that catch and complete that pass play for a first down for the Warriors, and now they'll be forced to punt. Line of scrimmage, they're the North Gwinnett 47-yard line. The quarterback Queen is also the punter. And a whistle blows the play dead.
Man, are you
it's
so
like
right
timeout
about that.
Called by North Gwinnett.
You're so right about that. Cray has to come down with that catch. As we got a timeout on the field, he has to be able to catch that and be able to come down with it. They need those big plays versus North Gwinnett. Those are the plays you got to have. If you don't have them, you really have no chance.
Number 28, Austin Kim.
As you can see, North Gwinnett is wearing all gray uniforms tonight. It's a cause that it's really dear to their hearts. First time they ever wore all gray. And it's for Cooper O'Brien, a fellow teammate. Last year came down with clear cell sarcoma. Only less than 1% of people have it. And unfortunately, he passed away. But they're in his remembrance, wearing all gray tonight in his remembrance, which is an awesome thing. And it's good to see a whole community coming in and bonding for an individual with a rare form of cancer.
And that's what North Gwinnett Athletic Director Grady York was telling us about before tonight's game. The clear cell sarcoma, such a rare disease, a form of cancer. And as DJ mentioned, took the life of Cooper O'Brien. They're going to have a benefit here at Tom Robinson Field, October 17th, as Queen punts it away. Big kick fielded by Chase Young. And he'll get it out beyond the 10-yard line, but not much further than that. October 17th, North Gwinnett Athletic Department will host a tremendous fundraiser, and they asked us to help spread the word. And if you ever have a chance to check out the Gwinnett newspaper or the AGJC, I'm sure they'll have coverage of it. Or you can go to the North Gwinnett High School website and learn more about the fundraiser on October 17th. They'll have a pumpkin patch and lots of great things for the kids and families, and they'd really love to see a lot of support for the O'Brien family, who lost their son Cooper to a rare form of cancer this past summer. Russell stays in at quarterback for North Gwinnett, and he hands it off up the middle to number 27, Jordan Fry.
Yeah, not sure what's going on, if John is all right or is he injured, doesn't have his helmet on, like he's giving the signals down at the bottom, but maybe just a changeup. This is, I mean, when I played, it's hard to really prepare for two quarterbacks, and they got two guys who can play the position.
Russell, also a senior, 6 foot, 175 pounds. And he scored the touchdown on the Bulldogs' last drive. Right now, it's second and five from their own 17. Keeping it on the ground. As we hit the 4.5 minute mark, Jordan Fry, the ball carrier that time. And yet another flag comes out in the secondary.
That penalty came from way back. You gotta wonder what that penalty was. Saw something from the far back, but looks like it's on North Cobb.
Mike Boyd is our referee.
Sideline infraction on North Gwinnett.
That's where the assistant coaches have to come in and keep the players back.
Used to hate those guys on it. Used to have those guys on the sideline. They're yelling, back up, back up. Used to hate those guys. Always telling you to get back, but hey.
There you go.
That's why they have them. Next time it's going to be a real penalty.
They'll be making that point in their video session Monday. So after the flag, a first and 10 from their own 23-yard line. The Bulldogs sticking to the ground game. Fry, the ball carrier again.
We had an ISO cam on Mitch Hyatt. Mitch Hyatt just drove his man 15 yards down the field and pancaked him. And you wondering why this kid's going to Clemson? Good gracious alive.
So Russell is still in the game. He'll be in the backfield with Urzua, who has returned to the action. And they got three wide on the left side. Urzua gives it to Russell. No, he faked it to Russell, and Urzua goes down the field, down the left side. And incomplete.
Thought he had a chance, and he thought he was going to come down with it.
Intended for Josh Amator Bebe.
That's all you can do is give him a chance. Both guys had a chance, said it. You give your playmaker a chance to make a play on the football. He almost came down with it. Nothing wrong with that call on second down. Good job of eluding the defensive player and giving your guy a chance. Sure, let's take that matchup anytime.
Good pressure on the quarterback that time by Scotty Cartledge of North Cobb. Third and seven for the Bulldogs. Russell, the quarterback, looking for the screen out of the backfield, intended for Pickett, but too much traffic, and the ball falls incomplete.
Very long, looking for the screen.
Cale Reed in there to break up that screen pass.
North Cobb waiting on that screen pass. Good job of them coming down and being active up front. Cale Reed just talked about the junior inside linebacker. Good job of him smelling that out.
All right, fourth and seven. They're lined up for a punt, but I'm not convinced. Keep your eyes on the screen, and yet another whistle stops play. And North Cobb calls timeout.
Absolutely. I would have called timeout, too.
Right.
He's telling them, listen, they are liable to do anything right now. We're playing, going to play punt safe, not going to give up anything. Give our offense the ball back with 3 minutes and 23 seconds to go to see if they can get something before the half.
Second timeout burned by head coach Shane Queen and the Warriors. So again, as DJ mentioned, a little more than 3 minutes to go. They'll have just one timeout remaining, and they hope that they will get the football back on this punt situation for the Bulldogs.
Well, Coach Spire, you never know. He showed a couple trick plays in the first half already. You never know what could happen. He could give you the loop-de-loop.
Absolutely. Jason Thompson is the special teams coordinator for the Bulldogs. All I can say is that the Bulldogs are in punt formation.
This is the opposite formation they had last time. Will we finally see a punt?
The snapper is Mitchell Gladstein, and yes, we will, as Harvey boots it away. A good high punt.
Oh,
and fielded poorly by the Warriors, and North Gwinnett says they have the ball. The punt returner, number 18, Drew Techman, dropped it as soon as it hit his hands, but he was able to recover, luckily, for the Warriors. So they will take over on their own 40-yard line, first and 10, with 3 minutes and 15 seconds remaining in the half.
That's a great punt. It's high. It gave his guys a chance to get down the field, but lucky enough, the ball just straight too far away. It landed right in front of him. He was able to jump back on it.
By the way, we told you why they're wearing the gray uniforms, North Gwinnett. They look pretty sharp, too.
Yeah, they are nice. I'm not going to lie. They are pretty good looking.
First and 10 for the Warriors. Good penetration by the North Gwinnett defensive line, led by number 59, Michael Germano.
Might have been a little too much on that. They might have a little bit extra on the. The power drive to the ground.
Looks like there's the flag. Mike Boyd, personal foul against the Bulldogs. Little too much enthusiasm from Germano and company on that gang tackle.
I'm sure North Gwinnett's defensive coaches are not angry about that. They like their guys running to the football and being active. Defensive coordinator Robert Andrews, I'm sure he preaches. He wants all 11 hats to the football. Nice aggressive play there.
But it cost them 15 yards, and it's now first and 10 for the Warriors at the North Gwinnett 45-yard line.
With all that said, it cost you 15.
There you go. Tyler Queen handing it off up the middle. Good gain down to around the 43-yard line.
No rush here for North Cobb. They got plenty of time. They still got a timeout left on the screen, so they should have plenty of time to get down. They're already in North Gwinnett territory, so they got plenty of time to do what they want to do, run our pass.
Second and eight. Queen looking to throw down the right sideline and beyond the outstretched arms of number 21. But a flag comes in on the play, and it looks like it'll be pass interference against the Bulldogs. C.J. Cole, the intended receiver.
Here's the big thing, man. If he's running down the sideline, he has to give him room. He tries to cut him off as he's going to the sidelines. We get the pass interference call. He cuts him off as he goes to the sideline. He tries to run a wheel route down the sideline, and he cuts him off right here and never looks back. See how he cuts him off? He cuts him off and never gives him a chance to turn around. And they're gonna flag you for that every time.
Avery Elford, the guilty party on the pass interference call against North Gwinnett. First and 10 for the Warriors from the 28-yard line of the Bulldogs. Over the middle goes Tyler Queen to number 11, Billy Nichols. Breaks a tackle, fights for yardage. Looks like they might mark it at the 15.
Nice play right there on first down. Crossing route, know they were in man coverage. Easy pitch and catch, nice job of Billy Nichols getting upfield, making a play, and also making a guy miss.
Another first down for the Warriors. It'll be first and 10 from the Bulldog 15-yard line. A touchdown here for North Cobb would be crucial for them. Queen keeps it himself. Lots of running room up the middle. Fakes a man, breaks a tackle, uses his size, continues to fight for yardage as he gets it down to the 3-yard line, and more flags come in, but this time it might be a late hit against North Cobb.
Yeah, you're always going to catch the second guy coming in. It actually started with the North Gwinnett guy hitting the North Cobb guy. You're going to see North Cobb come over late. One of his offensive linemen trying to save his quarterback. Looks like he's going to go back after that amazing run right there by Tyler Queen, running over a guy at the 5-yard line.
Showing his size and strength.
Can't emphasize enough how big and strong Tyler Queen is at 230 pounds when he runs a football.
6'3" tall as well, as the referees get together and discuss who the guilty parties are. Going to be a very...
It might just offset just because there was so much action going on. We'll see.
Personal foul against the Bulldogs. Yep, like you said, DJ, offsetting.
All for nothing here. You see a good run here. We're going to see at the 5-yard line, this wall, 230-pound comes in. Oh, get off me.
Just runs right over Andriski.
He's still running.
And Austin Kemp.
And here's where the penalty comes in. Wow, there's the late hit. And then there's number 59 coming in with the late hit. He has to get the reaction. So usually they caught both. It's a good job of Stephen Overlake trying to come in and get that last block. But, hey, you're going to get that 15-yarder right back at him.
So it looks like the referees are still trying to determine the correct line of scrimmage. Right now the ball rests at the 17-yard line of the Bulldogs.
Well, I'm thinking if it's offsetting penalty, you just replay it down.
That's right.
Replay it from where it was.
The last play was a first and 10.
Yeah, Coach
Queen's
over there.
So they should just wipe away the play and make it first and 10 again. Yeah, as you said, Coach Shane Queen looking for an explanation from referee Mike Boyd.
He's not understanding how we went first and 10 and now we're behind the chains.
You're backing us up. What's going on? My kid ran the ball to the 3-yard line. You're saying it's offsetting, and now we're losing 2 yards on the play. That doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, he's still arguing back and forth. Now the refs are coming back. They're talking about it again now.
Well, they need to, DJ, because this isn't right. This isn't the right call. The right call should be first and 10 from the 15-yard line. They still haven't Now they're moving the sticks back, which doesn't make any sense at all. They're compounding their mistake.
Well, I guess they're saying the ball was on the 17-yard line, not
but
the 15.
But it wasn't. Our records show it was on the 15-yard line. Now Bob's fire wants an explanation. Whatever he hears, look at him smiling.
I got 2 yards.
He is sly like a fox.
I got 2 yards.
I'm telling you, man, he's something else.
I take those 2 yards.
Bob's fire in his ninth year at North Gwinnett. He's averaged more than 10 wins a season in his Bulldog career. He's got a great program over here in Sewanee, Georgia. All right, it's first and 10 from the 17-yard line. That's what the refs decided, even though we disagree. Man in motion for the Warriors. Oh, big blitz coming, and Queen just has to throw it into the ground. Too much pressure led by Parker Seacrest and Matthew Andriski.
North Gwinnett goes cover zero, which means they have no safety in the middle of the field. They bring every blitzer they can. North Cobb has the perfect call, a screen into it. Tyler doesn't have enough time to get it off, but that was a walk-in touchdown.
So it'll be second and 10 now, still from the 17-yard line. Better protection this time for the Warriors. Queen going to the corner. He's got a man caught. Touchdown, North Cobb, but yet another flag comes out. Holding is the preliminary call, so the touchdown will be wiped off the board. But, man, that was a good-looking play.
That's how you diagram it when you open up the first day of camp. That's how it should look when you're throwing on 707 on air. That's an excellent pitch and catch, but it's all for nothing.
I tell you, if I'm head coach Shane Queen, I'm pretty ticked off right now. He's got to be very frustrated.
It's going back and forth, though, man. I tell you, North Gwinnett's had a couple of questionable pass interference calls.
But you know that they can call holding in football on every single play.
Very true.
And they picked that play after they robbed him of 2 yards to call holding. That's what I'm talking about.
Very true.
All right, now it's second down and 27 for the Warriors. Queen rolling right, chased out of the pocket, throws to the end zone, showing the arm strength, and grabbed by number 18, Andrew Lubbers, all the way down to the 1 yard line. A huge gain of 32 yards.
Here's a Division I throw, here's a Division I catch. College coaches are just salivating at the mouth right now at this play. That's the previous play of the screen where they went cover zero. But what a play, rolling to his right, throwing across his body and being accurate and dropping it on the dime at the 1 yard line for a big play.
And a great catch with strong hands by number 18, Andrew Lubbers. First and goal from the one for the Warriors. They give it to Cameron Pickett and he loses a yard. Check that, Bryce Perryman the ball carry.
I'm not sure North Cobb not even mad about this, because I'm sure they didn't want to leave North Gwinnett with any time on the clock. So this is probably
ideal.
Not a bad situation. But if I was a bed man, Van Earl, I would say this ball somehow, some way is going to end up in number 15's hand.
I would agree with that. Second and goal from the 3. There you go, Queen up the middle, trying to bulldoze his way in. But Mitch Hyatt continuing to play a lot on defense. Big Mitch Hyatt grabbed him by the ankles and denied him of the end zone.
Hey, well, you got players on this team that can make plays, offense, defense, it doesn't matter. Big Mitch Hyatt, you see the big Clemson commit right in the middle of the scrum, making plays. He's an athlete now.
But back to the 1 yard line on the run by Queen. And it's third and goal. Queen keeps it himself. Crosses the goal line. Touchdown signal by the linesman. Touchdown North Cobb. And a huge score by the Warriors with 39 seconds to go on the 11th play of the drive.
Well, it looks like I won my bet there, man. It had to be in his hands. He's a senior. He has to wheel his way into the end zone. And that's what we talked about in the open. All 230 pounds, he's using it all in this game tonight.
Now here's Will Horton on. He missed his first PAT. Here's his second try. That one is good. It's a two-point ball game. Big touchdown by Tyler Queen on a 10-play drive by the Warriors. 15-13, North Gwinnett leads this Friday night football game from the Channel 2 Sports Zone on WSBTV.com, presented by the Georgia Lottery. North Cobb about to kick it off after cutting the North Gwinnett lead from 9 to 2 points. 39 seconds remain here in the first half. Will Horton will kick it away for the Warriors. Pooch kick, fielded inside the 30-yard line, fielded by number 25, Brian Eberhardt for the Bulldogs.
Not sure if they want to get something here with 39 seconds to go. It's a possibility, though. The way they throw it around, it's a good chance they can.
Nope.
Here's a look at that great play by Tyler Queen and the catch made by number 18, Andrew Lubbers, right down to the one-yard line, the big play of the touchdown drive.
40 yards on his right side. That's an outstanding throw, 40 yards on the rope there.
First and 10 for the Bulldogs. Urzua looking over the middle, caught. Complete to Knutson. Look at him fight for extra yards. Getting it out to the 39-yard line, but the clock is ticking now, under 30 seconds to go in the first half. A gain of 11 yards.
North Gwinnett still has two timeouts, so they can use these timeouts. Probably one coming after this play.
Urzua, all kinds of time. No pressure at all. Complete, and the receiver gets out of bounds. That's complete to Eberhardt, number 25, and he gets it. The Bulldogs do get it into North Cobb territory with 20 seconds to go, and the clock is stopped, a gain of 16.
That's even better right there, of getting a play to get out of bounds, save your timeouts. Now you're in North Cobb territory driving.
First and 10 for the Bulldogs. A little reverse, Knutson back to Urzua. Double reverse, Urzua has a man. Caught inside the 5-yard line.
What a
throw. 11 for the Bulldogs. KJ Hancock, a gain of 43. Another beautiful trick play from Bob Spire and the Bulldogs.
What a play. What a big throw. What a big catch.
John Rosa
coming back and throwing a bomb. Big catch on the outside by number 11. Awesome job.
The reverse and the flea flicker to the quarterback. Pickett to Knutson, back to Urzua, and then he finds Hancock behind the defensive back.
What a play. Look at this. Look at the concentration.
Wow.
With an arm in there, still being able to hold on to it.
Exactly, and beautifully accurate pass as well. And, man, Bob Spire calls timeout. He's got a big smile on his face. And just when North Cobb thought they had grabbed the momentum, here comes the Bulldogs as they – took the control with less than 40 seconds remaining in the first half. 39 seconds on the clock when this drive started. Had one completion, then a big gain of 16 yards, got out of bounds, stopped the clock, and now the flea flicker reverse. I don't know what to call all these reverse plays or trick plays. Now it's first and 10, 12 seconds to go. North Gwinnett still has one timeout remaining. They can keep it on the ground with that one timeout, or they can go to the air.
You're right, Vander. They got all type of stuff happening here. Good chance of getting up for more scores.
Direct snap, and oh, it's a jump pass to Almonzo Brown. Touchdown, North Gwinnett. Oh, my goodness. I mean, it's just never it never stops.
What a play call. I don't know where Coach Byer gets all these plays from, but he has them galore. I mean, he has a whole playbook just for this. He has to.
Urzua leaves the backfield. Direct snap to number 30, Jordan Weddington, and he does a Tim Tebow jump pass to Almonzo Brown. Oh, my gosh.
Oh, man, this is exciting to watch. This has been the half of the tricks. Look at Coach Byer. He knows he's got something in his sleeve right now.
Look, he is something else.
Oh, man. Coach Byer, you are the king of the trick plays, I'm telling you. And they're going for two.
Urzua with a loaded backfield. Play action. Wide open receiver. Amator Bebe. Two more points for North Gwinnett. And they increase their lead to 10.
That is not how you want to end this half if you're North Cobb getting a big score. And North Gwinnett comes down with 39 seconds and gets a score. 36. Look at the jump pass. Jump pass.
Look at how open the receivers are.
Wow.
Amator Bebe and Almonzo Brown. And Urzua, the quarterback, is way over there on the right side. Hey, let me tell you something. All these change in formations, even the referees can't keep up with all that stuff.
Absolutely. I mean, just imagine preparing for this North Gwinnett team if you're a coach, if you're a defensive coach.
Amazing stuff. Fun stuff.
Absolutely.
North Cobb, though, has been fighting. They are determined to stay in this game. They've had a great touchdown drive. They cut the North Gwinnett lead to 2 with a big 11-play drive. And they scored with 39 seconds to go to cut the North Gwinnett lead to 2. But then, let me see, in 30 seconds of game time, the Bulldogs come right back and use some fantastic play calling by Bob Spire and some fantastic execution as well by the Bulldog offense. Harvey with the squib kick to try to use as much of the clock as he can. Fielded inside the 25-yard line by the Warriors. And number 10 gets it out to the 26, Jai Bishop Gray.
Well, Kyle better sit on this thing and just take it in halftime. Oh, man, what an interesting first half we have.
Seven seconds remain on the clock. It's a 10-point North Gwinnett ball game, 23-13. The North Cobb team has got to be not only frustrated, but a little stunned as well.
They're reeling from what just happened. Thought they would at least go in a half, only down by 2. Now they found themselves down by 10.
Tyler Queen takes a knee, and the half will end after North Gwinnett scores a touchdown with 9 seconds to go. What a first half of action here at Tom Robinson Field. DJ Shockley, Vanner, all right?
Vanner, I can see your heart still pumping through the chest.
You too, man.
It's an exciting first half. I'm loving it, though.
Great way to start our 2014 season here on WSBTV.com. North Cobb and North Gwinnett getting after it here in Sewanee, Georgia. And if only the second half can be maybe just half as entertaining as the first,
absolutely,
you should stick around. But stick around as well for our halftime activities, because coming up after the break, Michael Carvel, the AJC college football recruiting expert, will be with us and join us and offer his insight on the top prospects, some of whom are playing in this game tonight. Stick around. You're watching Friday Night Football from the Channel 2 Sports Zone on WSBTV.com, presented by the Georgia Lottery. Thanks, good hustle. We are back at Tom Robinson Field, moments away from the second half, where North Gwinnett leads North Cobb 23-13, along with DJ Shockley. I'm Van Earl Wright. You're looking at the Warriors of North Cobb warming up and getting ready to try to hike the comeback trail down by 10. You know, I got to be honest with you, DJ. I'm like, am I being too partial to North Gwinnett in the announcing from the first half? But the play calling is so unique and exciting, yeah. You can't help but react.
It's tough. It's a tough call. And you look at everything they're doing up front. They're doing some spectacular things that get you excited. North Cobb doing some good things as well. You talk about Tyler Queen doing some stuff, running the football, using his big frame to be able to take some guys down the field, but also throwing the football really well. They need to stop North Gwinnett right now. That's what they need. They need to get a couple stops on defense so they can get back and just stop it. Here's some of the stuff we've seen from the first half. And started out with John Azul trying to make some plays, but this is where he just throws back into traffic, the interception, and this leads to a 10-play, 96-yard drive for North Cobb for a touchdown.
And that was a really big positive moment. Not only that interception, but that 96-yard drive, keyed that time by that huge run that got it across midfield. A great run by Tyjae Bronner, just part of that 96-yard drive. Tyler Queen moved him down into the red zone and completed the touchdown toss to Jordan McCray, and North Cobb was looking good. Then North Gwinnett came right back. Cameron Pickett getting it into the end zone. And then the trick play started. Knudsen to the backup quarterback, Russell. A wall, a convoy of blockers, as DJ pointed out, made it easy into the end zone for Russell. Then Queen with a big, strong run, just bulldozing would-be tacklers. That play actually would be called back, but it showed the strength of the North Cobb quarterback.
And here's the most spectacular play I thought was right here. 40 yards on the rope, going through his right, coming back, and what a great catch at the one-yard line. Tyler would eventually run that in from the one-yard line. And here's another trick play right before the half. John Azua, big bomb down the right side. Great catch, sets him up at the one-yard line.
K.J. Hancock on the receiving end of that, and then the jump TD toss a la Tim Tebow. Almonzo Brown with the reception on that touchdown toss. And right now, after a couple of two-point conversions, after a fake punt, North Gwinnett leads it 23-13. And don't forget, last weekend in really impressive heat, yes, they did start late, but still a hot night
start.
North Gwinnett beat number one McEachern 52-49 in a game that did not end until close to 2 a.m. Sunday morning.
So right now, this is early. This is early for them. This is early morning playing right now compared to last week. But they're battle tested, going against number one McEachern, going back and forth, playing against a really solid team. They're used to this type of affair. If North Cobb ready for what's going to happen in the second half, they better be, or they'd be 0-2 soon.
Well, when we talked to North Gwinnett head coach Bob Spire earlier this week, I was saying, how about this back and forth action? He's like, well, you know, when we fell behind 21-7 to McEachern, it was just kind of like, well, game on, fellas. Here we go.
They're used to
it. It's time to start playing.
They're used to it. He said his team is built. That's how they're built. They're built around coming back sometimes, and they don't really lose their grasp. And that's where it comes from, the senior quarterback, John Azua, being a guy who's very, very calm. He's collected. He's poised. He has the presence of a guy who's been starting for years. So you got to respect it. You got to love it. And his coach, his team, they all take after his demeanor.
And if you're Shane Queen, head coach of the Warriors of North Cobb, what do you think he was telling his team in the locker room at halftime?
Well, you know, he's telling them right now, hey, we're only two or three plays away from being in this thing. If we do not allow the big play before the half, this is a two-point ball game right now. There are a couple big plays that they're having that they did not have in the first quarter, and they're just starting to get some big plays. If we cut back on the big plays, play responsible football, we'll be right back in this ball game.
Moments away from the second half kickoff. Remember, at the beginning of the game, North Cobb won the coin toss they elected to receive. So North Gwinnett will start the second half with the football and a 10-point lead. Another big crowd on hand here at Tom Robinson Field at North Gwinnett High School, located in Sewanee. The Warriors of North Cobb, as DJ pointed out, reminding themselves that they're only trailing by 10.
It may seem like it's more just because North Gwinnett's had so many big plays.
Right.
You feel like they should be down by more. But this North Cobb team is still in it. They got to play their brand of football, and they'll be just fine coming out here in the second half.
Great way to start our season-long coverage of Friday Night Football out of the Channel 2 Sports Zone here on WSBTV.com. We certainly hope that you will join us each and every Friday night. Streaming live can be seen wherever you have that internet connection. Watch it on your smartphone, ladies and gentlemen. You can go to the movies, and you can watch the movie, and watch a little football on your phone. But make sure you mute the volume. No, don't mute the volume.
Don't mute us. No, absolutely not.
Little pooch kick from North Cobb to start the second half. Fielded at the North Gwinnett 25-yard line by number 25, Brian Eberhardt. The third kickoff he's fielded tonight. And now John Urzua and the Bulldogs of North Gwinnett will get set for their first drive of the second half.
That first half couldn't go even better for this North Gwinnett offense, how they ended the first half. Now they're going into the second half, and some stats from the first half. You look at North Cobb, 138 yards passing, 146 rushing the football.
Pretty balanced.
82 rushing and 186 passing. So pretty balanced on both sides.
First and 10 for North Gwinnett from their own 35-yard line as we get going here in the second half on WSBTV.com. Urzua looking left. Inside slant play in and out of the hands of Almanzo Brown. I thought maybe for a second it was going to be picked off. Good coverage that time from number 23, Gilbert Blow.
Nice ball, nice catch. You think he got to come down with that. That's a catch that you've seen him make. It's a catch that he will make in the future. He was stumbling coming out of the break. But that's one play he will come down with if it comes his way again. Almanzo Brown is made for that. He's a senior. Coach says he's one of the smartest players on the team.
Urzua has a running back in the backfield with him, and he hands it off to number 27, Jordan Fry, who looks for room on the outside, on the left side.
Perfect start for this North Cobb defense already. Not much brewing on offense, brings up a third and long. We know this offense can put up some big yards if intended, but great start for North Cobb's defense, forcing them into a third and long situation.
Third and 10. They've gained 0 yards so far in two plays. There's Zua looking to go to the air. Flag flies, caught by Josh Amator Bebe. He put the football on the ground. Now they're signaling incompletion, and the flag is a preliminary holding call against the Bulldogs that will back them up deeper into their own territory.
Yeah, they're going to.
Not a very good opening drive.
They're going to decline that and take it to fourth down. And just like North Cobb probably talked about at halftime, defense, get us a stop, get the ball back to our offense, give us a chance, and turn this into a three-point ball game. It's a great start for North Cobb on defense, but North Gwinnett, now what they wanted offensively.
0 yards gained in three plays by the Bulldogs, so they'll be forced to kick it away. Line of scrimmage is their own 35-yard line. Two men back to field the punt for the Warriors. Harrison Barron, the late addition to the punt team for the Bulldogs. End over end punt. Kind of a dead ball bounce. Looks like it'll be fielded right at the 31-yard line of North Cobb. And that's where Tyler Queen and the Warriors will take over for their first drive of the second half.
Can the senior be even bigger right now? Can the senior have a big moment in this ball game, bring his squad back? Only down 10 early in the third quarter here. Can Tyler Queen do the job right here on this series, actually?
Tyler Queen, number 15, 6'3", 230 pounds, committed to Auburn before his junior season. Keeps it himself. Good penetration. Number 91, Dixon Yellott, a sophomore defensive lineman for the Bulldogs, makes the stop. A gain of one on the play.
North Gwinnett defense trying to stay at home, not giving Tyler Queen the presence to make any big plays early.
Queen hanging tough in the pocket and picked off over the middle by Parker Seacrest, the middle linebacker right there at the right time, and returns it all the way down to the 25-yard line of North Cobb. And just as you were talking about, DJ, here's an opportunity for North Cobb to take control, and North Gwinnett denies him.
Yeah, that's not what you want if you're Tyler Queen. He just did not see the dropping linebacker in coverage. That's one he's going to watch on film and wish he had back, trying to fit it into a tight window. He has to move on in his progression and find another receiver. Now he's flipping it back over. North Gwinnett's turn now. Make this lead even bigger. As the replay shows here, he tries to sit in the pocket and tries to deliver, which is, he stands in there long, long, long stretching and tries to fit it in. And it's not a good decision.
So first and 10 from the 26. Hand off to Cameron Pickett right up the middle for the Bulldogs. Good gain of about 5 or 6 yards for the Bulldogs.
Big first down run there. Obviously, good job of getting upfield. Offensive line being very physical up front, pushing the D-line back. And that's where Coach Queen said, hey, we're just not as physical and not as big as he wants up front.
Second and 4 from the 20-yard line for the Bulldogs. Again, they handle off to Pickett. Lots of room right side. Gets it inside the 15-yard line. Stays on his feet. Touchdown, North Gwinnett. Touchdown, Cameron Pickett.
There is the want-to by Mr. Pickett. He wanted to get in the end zone. He fought hard, and there's a capitalizing on the turnover. North Gwinnett taking a huge lead now.
20-yard touchdown romp, and I mean that was a romp. That was not a run. He was just bulldozing.
I want it more than you want it. North Gwinnett has that feeling right now, like they're going to take this game over and put it away.
Brad Harvey will try for the point after to make it a 17-point ball game. The snapper is Mitchell Gladstein. And here comes a fake. Number 14, the holder. Oh, he loses the football, recovered by North Cobb. So that's the first trick play that did not work for Bob Spier and the Bulldogs.
I don't know if he was trying to do a trick play on that one. Looks like might have had a low snap or something, and he's just trying to make it out a better play. But as you can see, Mr. Pickett there on the sideline having a heck of a run there getting into the end zone.
North Gwinnett leads by 16. You're watching Friday Night Football presented by the Georgia Lottery. Just under 10 minutes to go here early in the third quarter, and North Gwinnett increases their lead from 10 to 16 after a two-play 26-yard touchdown drive that was preceded by a Parker Seacrest interception. Kick by Brad Harvey goes into the Warrior end zone, so they'll bring it out for the touchback.
Go back and look at the touchdown run here. Nothing but an outside zone here. He actually cuts it back to the right side. Good job of walling everything down. And now this is just pure desire. This is just him wanting it, running over guys, and maybe able to keep his balance and have him get in the end zone. What a great run.
Drew Beckman, high Bishop Gray, unable to stop. Number five in Gray, Cameron Pickett. And here comes Tyler Queen and the Warrior offense again for their second drive of the second half. Swinging it out to Perryman. Good gain on first down.
That's what they need on first down. Positive yardage plays. Something quick that gets the ball in open space for his playmakers to make plays. But other than that, positive yardage. More than anything, this offense has gone backwards a few times. Positive yardage on first down.
Resulting in second and four for the Warriors. Lots of traffic in the middle.
Yeah, just
Queen
tough sled.
Queen kept it himself.
Tough sled for Queen up front. They're trying to make sure he doesn't beat him, especially through the run game. He's had a tough one running.
Now Queen looking over to his dad and offensive coordinator Chad McGee for a little audible. Third and two for the Warriors. Pass over the middle and caught by number 30. That's Quanti Green. He's off and running. Quanti Green is not going to be stopped. Touchdown, North Cobb.
Now we got something brewing. North Cobb gets something going. Tyler makes a huge throw. He makes everything happen after the game. What a huge play on offense by Quanti Green.
72 yards on the touchdown play. Quanti Green made one move inside and he was gone.
He was gone. You thought he might have been caught, but he actually has a 4-4 speed himself. And what a great drawn up play on the outside by Coach Shane Queen.
And Shane Queen, not only excited about the execution of the play, also thrilled that the referees kept their flags in their pockets. Shane Queen and the Warriors going for two after the 72-yard touchdown romp, and it is good with the completion to Billy Nichols on the slant pattern. So just like that, the Warriors of North Cobb cut the Bulldogs' lead to 8-29-21. You're watching Georgia High School Football on WSBTV.com, presented by the Georgia Lottery.
That's why I said good play call. Because usually they do that and they throw that sling route to you. Nothing but a decoy.
Set for the kickoff from Will Horton. Two Bulldogs deep, and they stand at their 15-yard line as once again Horton pooch kicks it, and once again Eberhardt fields it, but this time he's on the move and gets it out beyond the North Gwinnett 35-yard line.
All right, it's time for Northwest Gwinnett turn to respond now. I think Cobb's starting to get a little momentum, and here's the replay of it. This is a great throw. He takes the air out of it. Safety overruns it. And just a great job by Quarter Green, making it miss and then turning on the Jets with a great decoy route. You see by the running back coming out of the backfield. Good read by Tyler Queen for the TD.
72 yards on that touchdown pass for North Cobb, making it an 8-point ball game. John Urzua, the quarterback for North Gwinnett. He's got Cameron Pickett in the backfield, and he hands it to him. Pickett picks up three or four on the right side. Oh, and a cheap shot by number 17, Chandler Wooten, a sophomore, took out his frustrations and drew the flag from referee Mike Boyd. That'll be a personal foul.
That's just what you can't have.
That's a sophomore
momentum
move.
On your side. That is definitely a sophomore move. I'm sure coach is calling him to the side. He's going to give him an earful.
Yep, Chandler Wooten is already getting an earful on the North Cobb sideline.
It's just something you can't do, giving them a whole 15-yard. This offense doesn't need any more help.
No, they don't.
Than it already gets.
That was so unnecessary. The play had been dead for at least a couple of seconds. Sophomoric move.
Not good at all.
So that moves the line of scrimmage to the 47-yard line of North Cobb. Free gift wrap yardage that time. And Urzua has Weddington in the backfield with him on this play. Throws it to Weddington on the wheel route, coming out the left side, lots of room, right down the sideline, gets a block by Avatar Bebe, goes for the end zone, leans in. And the linesman, the back judge, says he's short. Says he stepped out inside the five, but we got a flag.
Holding.
DJ says holding on the Bulldogs.
That last block to spring in to get in the end zone was the one that they called. It looked good, but it's going to come all the way back.
Again, great execution by the Bulldogs, and DJ saw it. When it happened, he saw it before the ref saw it.
Hey, you got to see it. You're going to see the last block up here. I'm not sure who's blocking, but right up here at the top, right there.
I'm a Tor Bebe.
There was a hole right before that, before it comes in our screen, and that's where they threw the flag at. And that's why it's coming back after a huge game, but all for nothing.
The Gates, a 43-yard play for the Bulldogs. They'll bring it back to the 35-yard line. So another first and 10 situation for the team in gray, leading 29-21. There's Urzua to throw. He's got Knutson over the middle, but that throw from Urzua a little too high.
He kind of eyed his receiver down there. He had a single receiver route over there. He had him earlier in the route. He should have threw it earlier. I don't know what he's waiting on. No safety in the middle of the field. He got to deliver the ball on time. He wanted to see it open. That's where the inexperience of being just his 1 year comes in. Even though he has a lot of attempts, he still has that inexperience of anticipation of anticipating the throw.
Again, if you joined us late, Urzua coming off a week one performance when he threw the ball 48 times and finished with 498 yards through the air a week ago. That pass complete on the left side to number 13, Harold Johnson. A gain of four.
That gets him back in the third down. It's a little bit easier. This offense is made to pick up chunks of yards, but third and six is a lot easier than the third and long they've used to all night.
Here comes the sixth play of this current drive for the Bulldogs, line of scrimmage at the 30 of North Cobb. There's Zua, quick throw to Imator Bebe, the younger of the two brothers. His first name is Josh.
It's a good thing. You know what I like about John? John has a quick release. He doesn't really step into it as much, but he has a quick, and he's an accurate passer, which gives them an advantage. But here's the fourth down. It'd be huge if North Cobb could stop him right here.
Going to be fourth and one for the Bulldogs. No surprise that they're going for it. They're deep in North Cobb territory. Fry in the backfield with Urzua. As they look over to the bench, and now a timeout's going to be called by North Gwinnett head coach Bob Spire. So with 6:46 remaining here in the third quarter, we've got an 8-point ball game, and the team in gray is on top, 29-21. First timeout called in the second half.
Just because they call timeout don't mean they're going to necessarily kick it. It looks like they're bringing on the field goal kicker, but his offense would go for it. But I think they want to try to keep some momentum and not give it back to North Cobb here by going for it at least.
Well, the last time they lined up with this kick team, it wasn't the greatest of snaps, and Holder Andy Summers tried to improvise and found zero success as he lost the handle on the football. So if Harvey is able to complete this.
Coach talked about the 28-yard line being his
right
range. And
well,
we're about right on that.
It would be a 33-yard kick. And this is within Harvey's range. Hold by Summers is good. Kick by Harvey is hooked. Left side, field goal attempt, no good by Brad Harvey. So the lead for North Gwinnett remains 8 at 29-21.
Yeah, they had a chance there to give some confidence to the kicker. They gave him a chance to kick it. You got to like Coach Spire try
right
to give the guy some confidence kicking in a big-time game. Didn't happen, but that just means he has a lot of confidence in his defense.
6:41 to go, and here comes Tyler Queen and the Warriors of North Cobb yet again. Tyler Queen headed to Auburn University, 6'3", 230 pounds, and he hands it off to Perryman. Right side, picks up two or three on first down.
Not much on that first down. Trying to stay ahead of the chains. They've been known to get behind it, but Tyler Queen, if they're going to get back in this game, not much been going on the ground. They've got all the – everything they've done tonight has been in the gun throwing the football.
A gain of just one on that first down play, so it's second and nine for the Warriors. Queen, quick release, has his man, number 21. Complete to C.J. Cole. Gets it out close to the first down.
Yeah, man, nice job of him getting out his hands quick. Set up a real third and short here. This is way more manageable for this type of offense to pick up with a big quarterback that's 230 that can run the football downhill.
Here you can see just how big Tyler Queen is on a third and one. And he shows his strength and his size busting through the first line of defense from North Gwinnett. Picks up the first down and gets it out to the 35.
Yeah, anytime you get a third and short, you got to believe they're going to keep it in his hands, their most durable, their most trusting guy they got in their offense right now.
North Cobb on the move, trying to cut into North Gwinnett's 8-point lead. Quick release from Queen on a wide receiver screen but good penetration and breakup that time from the North Gwinnett defense. Pass complete to Jordan McCray.
I like what's going on up front for North Cobb. They're getting the ball out of Tyler's hands quick, trying to get it to the playmakers, and they're staying ahead of the chains right now, which is a good thing, making it easier for them once they get to a more pressure down, like third down.
Second and seven right now for North Cobb. Three wide on the left side for Tyler Queen. Bobbles that snap, finds lots of running room up the middle, gets it close to midfield, out to the 48-yard line.
Coach Spire talked about coming into this ball game, who was going to be the most concerned for you. He said, obviously, Tyler Queen is. This is nothing but a QB draw. And he takes it into his own hand, makes it happen, picks up big first down. I keep saying, chains are moving.
First and 10 from the 47. They hand it off to Perryman. He gets hit hard by number 56, Aaron Hart. But he gets it across midfield and into Bulldog territory.
Staying ahead of the chains. It's so important for this offense to do so, because every time they do not, they end up with a penalty, a holding call that gets them behind the chains, and it's hard for them to come back after something like that with a good defense like North Gwinnett's having tonight.
Second and five from the Bulldog 47-yard line for the Warriors. Oh, pass wow. Rush and sacked. Avery Elford with the blitz, and he drops Queen for about a 5-yard loss.
Yeah, this is on the running back here. The running back has to do a better job of blocking. And you're looking at Bryce Perryman right here. As soon as he gets outside, that's his guy that he just turns loose. And that's the only reason why Tyler's not able to get around the edge, because he missed his block. You see it with his hands on his head right there, knowing he missed his block.
A loss of 7 on that play. Bad mistake by Perryman. And another blitz. Queen lets it go and caught. Complete. Down to number 24, DJ Render. Huge gain on the play. And again, the strength of Tyler Queen hanging tough with the rusher right in his face. A gain of 31.
You keep mentioning it. He is a tough kid. He hung in there and gave the guy some good touch on the football. He wasn't even out of his break. He gave him great touch, and the ball dropped right in the bucket.
First and 10 from the North Gwinnett 28. Warriors on the move. What a play by Tyler Queen with that great completion to DJ Render. This time, Queen keeps it himself, gets it inside the 25 down to the 24-yard line.
I mean, we just can't stress enough how tough Tyler Queen is, what he's doing for this offense. North Gwinnett's hitting him every single time he carries the football. But look at this play here. Watch him step into it. Look at the touch. Now he finally comes out of his break, and it's just perfect. That's why Auburn is so excited to have this kid.
Quick release on a wide receiver screen. Caught by Jordan McCray, right side. Gets it inside the 20. The Warriors continue to move down the field. They're now in the red zone.
This has been an outstanding drive for North Cobb. They've done nothing to hurt themselves. They kept going forward.
And another third and short situation now, DJ.
I wonder who's going to have the football, Van Earl.
Yeah. Third and one from the 19. There you go.
That was a surprise.
Tackled from behind by number 71, Andre Saint-Amour, the senior defensive end for the Bulldogs.
Hey, when he's your quarterback and it's third and short, I don't know why there's a second thought about anybody else carrying the football. He doesn't turn it over. He's had the one interception tonight, but he does a good job with the football, and he gets north and south.
That's almost as predictable as Bob Spire calling a few trick plays in a football game, right?
It's guaranteed to happen, right?
Here comes the 12th play of this current drive for North Cobb. And this time, it's offside against the Bulldogs, so everything continuing to work very smoothly for the Warriors on this current drive.
That's a senior that doing it for you offensively. That's a senior being smart, taking some free yards. Free yards, I love those with the false starts up front by the offsides by the defense.
And a clock-consuming drive as well. Less than 2:40 to go. Throw to the end zone by Queen. Off the mark that time. Intended for Render again.
They went back to the big play they had on third down. They just could not get in contact with his receiver there. He gave him a chance, but like he stumbled coming out of it. DJ Render had a chance at it, though. Big second down here within on the 11-yard line. Tyler Queen.
Queen kept it himself and was dropped for a loss. A big play defensively by Michael Germano, who spent a lot of time in the North Cobb backfield tonight.
Maybe one of the decisions that Tyler would want back, he would probably wish he could have gave that ball away, because everybody was keying on the big 230-pound quarterback.
Loss of three on the play, and now it's third and long. The line of scrimmage is the 14-yard line. Third and eight for Queen and the Warriors. Harassed, trying to stay alive, avoids Mitch Hyatt. Throws to the end zone, up for grabs. A flag comes out, but I'm not sure that ball would have been catchable. The refs will have to talk about it. But when you see a flag in that situation, you're thinking pass interference.
Man, you know what just happened there? Clemson versus Auburn. That's what just happened right there. Looks like Auburn got the most out of Mitch Hyatt right there. Good battle going up front. Mitch Hyatt almost had him.
Pass interference on the offense.
Wow.
Wow is right.
That's a first. That's tough to call right there. Both guys are battling. Here's Mitch Hyatt, number 75.
Oh,
beats
my.
A double team. He has him in his grasp. Mitch is like, what I got to do to get this guy? And you see the athleticism right there of Tyler Queen. Not sure where the P.I.
I didn't see that.
But it was thrown late, too.
And the receiver's already out of bounds, so the ball was basically uncatchable. One of those situations where you want the refs just to pick up the flag. And now North Cobb has called timeout, their first of the second half. So far, it's been a 14-play drive for the Warriors, but right now they're facing a third and 23. Once they got into the red zone, they started backing up, unfortunately, for the Warriors.
Yeah, they were doing everything right on this drive, staying ahead of the chains, not causing unforced penalties. Now they're kind of hurting themselves and taking themselves out of field goal range. A big third down here, so not sure what you call here. They got screens, draws, maybe one of those bubble screens that they've been doing all night. It's a tough call here on third and long.
Right now, with the ball at the 29-yard line, that's pushing it for kicker Will Horton. Head coach Shane Queen told us 40 yards is about his max, so that means it would be a 36-yard field goal attempt right now with the line of scrimmage being the 29-yard line. But it's still third down for the Warriors, third and 23. So if they can pick up some kind of yards here, at least that'll increase their chances for a field goal try if they come up short of the first down.
Big third down here. Handoff, Gwinnett, stand up, hold him.
Less than two to go in the third quarter. Queen gets better protection, throws towards the end zone.
Oh,
oh my, a little high for Lubbers.
He had what he wanted, too. He had him open. He hit his hands, had a chance to come down with it. So that's actually a good play call. North Cobb had exactly in the coverage they wanted. Only three rushers. Tyler Queen steps up in the pocket and delivers a good football.
Ooh.
Little high, but
should have
hit his hands. Should have been caught. You're right.
Tough moment for number 18 in white. So it looks like North Cobb is lined up to go for it on fourth and 23. Look out for the quick kick. Nope. Queen's looking to throw. Plenty of time. Staying behind the line of scrimmage and then knocked down by the big right hand of Mitch Hyatt. Oh, my goodness.
How satisfying is that for Mitch Hyatt? To be able to come back and get the tackle, the sack, whatever you want to call it. He says, I got you now, buddy. I got you. Now Clemson wins one for one right here tonight.
Queen did a good job of extending the play, but eventually tracked down by 75.
Look at Mitch getting that big paw on there. Thinking he probably popped it up. He's looking for a catch. The big paw was able to get a hand on Tyler Queen, forces a turnover.
So the ball goes over on downs with a minute 34. remaining here in the third quarter, and North Cobb, after a 16-play drive, comes up empty. Quick release by Urzua to number 13, Harold Johnson, went right through the hands of the intended receiver.
I mean, how fun is this for high school football? First you run down, and you run down Tyler Queen, then you turn around, and you're playing tackle and have to block a guy.
I tell you, number 75, no wonder.
Yeah.
He's rated as one of the top 10 linemen in the entire country. Now to his day job of left tackle. North Gwinnett stays on the ground, hands it off to Jordan Fry, picks up a few yards up the middle.
Here's where North Gwinnett's been really hurting North Cobb tonight on third down and long, actually. You'd think it'd be the other way around, but third and long, they find ways in his defense to get open. Interesting to see the play call here as the third quarter winds down.
Approaching the final minute of the third period, and it's a third and seven for the Bulldogs. Urzua, play action, pump fake, and complete over the middle to Imator Bebe. Josh Imator Bebe.
That's where they've been hurting North Cobb all night. They went with the fake screen and tried to get him running through the middle. All they needed was 7 yards. Good job of John just putting it on his body. Now Imator Bebe coming out with the catch.
They needed 7 and they picked up 10. So it's first and 10 from their own 41-yard line for North Gwinnett. Cameron Pickett, the ball carrier, gets it beyond the 45 out to the 47-yard line.
And look at North Gwinnett trying to go a little hurry up now. Trying to get another play in, maybe a couple more plays in before this quarter's over. Right back at North Cobb, give them no room to breathe.
Less than 20 seconds to go. Again, they hand it off to Pickett. Stopped that time by Scotty Cartledge and a couple other Warrior defenders.
Looks like that'll be the last play of the third quarter.
And that will do it. We are through three quarters here at Tom Robinson Field at North Gwinnett High School in Sewanee, Georgia. The home team in gray continues to lead it. The margin is 8. 29-21, you're watching Friday Night Football from the Channel 2 Sports Zone on WSBTV.com, presented by the Georgia Lottery. Here we go with the fourth quarter between North Gwinnett, who has 29 points, and North Cobb, who has 21. Bulldogs on the move. They cross midfield as they continue with this drive. Hand off to Weddington, who gets it down to, who picks up a first down by getting it to the 49-yard line.
Probably going to be a lot more of that in this fourth quarter, running this clock out, getting these running backs a lot of touches, keeping that clock rolling.
First and 10 for the Bulldogs. Urzua tipped, intended for Knutson. That one falls incomplete.
Nice job of getting a hand on it on the outside right there. North Cobb, not sure he got a hand on it, but good job of deflecting it. Looks like that may have had a seam to catch it, but brings up a second down here right near midfield.
Second and 10 from the 49 of North Cobb. This will be the eighth play of this current Bulldog drive. Plenty of time for Urzua going deep. He's got a man behind the coverage, but just a little too far for K.J. Hancock.
Oh, just maybe a yard overthrown of K.J. there with another big play perhaps in the making on that play. But good coverage, running step for step with K.J. John does a good job of giving his guys a chance as we watch the replay. John scans the field. Great coverage there. Both guys battling just a little bit far inside, outside, may have a chance.
Coverage from Torian St. Romain, the junior defensive back for the Warriors. Here comes the reverse, Almonzo Brown. I thought he was going to think about throwing it. Instead, he runs it, but a great read and a great tackle on that play by North Cobb's Drew Techman, the sophomore.
Matt Earl, it was only a matter of time before one happened. The trick play was almost on the rise up there. Coach Spires said, this game's getting a little boring right now. We gotta make sure we get it,
I guess so.
Get it going.
So now it's fourth and six for the Bulldogs. In North Cobb territory, head coach Bob Spire, not even thinking about it, going for it on fourth and six. But no, it's a quick kick from Urzua. Went off the side of his foot, but gets a great bounce. Look at that. All the way down to the 1 yard line and downed by Harold Johnson. Holy cow.
He can not only throw it, but he can kick it.
Wow.
That's a versatile QB. I'm not sure I can punt the football. I sure would try. That's a great punt.
48-yard quick kick. That's pretty good. Wow.
Quick kicks work too. Not mad at that at all.
Well, North Cobb already has one 96-yard touchdown drive in this game. So they got to believe they can do it now.
Well, if any time they need to do it,
there you go.
It's right now.
Trailing by eight with 10:39 remaining in the game.
Still lots of time to go in this game, but they need a huge drive right now.
I'm going to steal your line, DJ. I think Tyler's going to keep it himself. There you go.
That happened.
Gets it out beyond the five.
Just need a little breathing room to start their offense, get it going. Good job of Tyler getting some, finding some open area to get open and get some space.
So now, second and six from their own 5 yard line. Queen, I believe, for only the second time in this game, under center. Hands it off to Elijah Hairston, the 5'10" sophomore for the Warriors.
Another area where they're just trying to get some more room to call one of their better plays, and you see as the mass substitution comes in, Maybe Coach Queen has some up his sleeve right now with that mass substitution.
Third and three for the Warriors. Queen back to the shotgun. Has Perryman in the backfield. Keeps it himself. Gets it out beyond the 10-yard line. That'll be close to a first down.
Looks like he got it. Looks like the side jug gave him a very generous spot. And it is a first down.
First down, North Cobb.
Know they ran the ball first three times on this drive. Clock still continuing to run. The clock's going to stop at the first down, but they got to start putting it in the air.
Inside handoff to C.J. Cole. Not much there.
Not much brewing in the middle. Gwinnett's done a pretty good job in the trenches tonight, not giving up any big plays, rushing the football up the middle, but you can only think it's a matter of time before they put it outside and give one of their big receivers a chance to make a play.
No gain on the play. Ball carrier was Bryce Perriman. Second and 10, Queen moving to his right. Oh, miscommunication that time between McCray and Nichols. Both receivers thought it was intended for the other guy.
Nice roll out. I mean, he had what they wanted. He was coming open. Maybe he had to be angry. A half a second later, that football's on time. As you can see the replay here, he kind of gets caught up in the junk here. Yeah, he pulls his hand back like it wasn't for him.
That was Nichols pulling his hands back.
Nichols, as a receiver, you got to always want that football.
That's right. If it's out there, you got to go get it. Now third and 10 for the Warriors, and the Bulldog faithful rise to their feet. And Tyler Queen signals timeout. The first for the Warriors here in the second half.
Yeah, it looked like a little miscommunication. It looked like Tyler, he was the only one who wasn't on the same page as everybody else, looking down at his hand for the play. But it's a big, big third down. They got to make sure everybody's on the right page, receivers, running backs, offensive line, especially the quarterback, if they want to convert this third down.
That's Robert Andrews, defensive coordinator for the Bulldogs, in just his second year on Bob's Fire staff. He's a guy who grew up in Mississippi. Spent 8 years at Grayson High School. And last week, his defense gave up 470 yards to McEachern. That was an average of 8 yards a play. A lot of improvement here. Of course, a different kind of team from McEachern to North Cobb.
Yeah, McEachern had a pretty good running back who a lot of people consider one of the best in the state as well in the country, Todd Griffin.
Man, what an athlete.
Yeah, he was pretty good.
Unfortunately, he tore knee ligament in that game a week ago, and so sad to see that for a guy who's headed to Oregon, Taj Griffin and McEachern, because he was fun to watch. He was just leaving kids in his dust.
Yeah, it was fun to watch.
But he should come back and be a quality recruit for the Ducks. Here we go at third and 10 for the Warriors, three wide on the right, and a whistle blows the play dead.
North Cobb.
Illegal procedure, which will make it third and 15 for the Warriors. There's still a lot of time left, 8.5, DJ, but this is an ugly drive for the Warriors when they really needed to hold on to the football.
Yeah, it's tough right now, especially getting moved back into your own territory. Officials timeout here now to talk to Coach Spire.
Well, Tyler Queen first mentioned something to referee Mike Boyd, and it looked like Boyd agreed. So now he wants to talk. Oh, I see. He's doing, Tyler Queen was complaining about the North Gwinnett band playing when the referee whistled for play to begin. And Bob Spire says, I'm not the band director, I'm the football coach. Look at him, he's appealing to the band. Hey, guys, come on. You gotta stop. And they get louder.
He's just telling me, just turn your instruments down. Don't even look at the band's yelling at Coach Spire now. Like, it's our fault?
I know. The drum corps, they can't stop playing those drums. So the Bulldog faithful behind the Bulldog bench, they start stomping their feet and get even louder as they try to distract Queen and the Warriors, who are facing a third and 15 from their own 6-yard line. Queen going down the right side, looking for McCray. It looks like a catch, but was he in bounds? Yes, it is a catch out beyond the 35-yard line, all the way down to the 39. A gain of 34 yards on the play on third and 15. What a fantastic play from Queen to McCray.
Yeah, man, there are two seniors hooking up, 6'6". Jordan McCray outside making a big catch for his fellow senior quarterback, Tyler Queen.
First and 10 for the Warriors. Back to the ground game.
What a big play there by McCray. That was huge. That was monumental. They needed that. Tyler giving his big 6'6 wide out a chance. And And that's just great hand-eye coordination, man. To keep his feet in bounds as well. Nice job by McCray.
That was beautiful. Second and 8 now for the Warriors after a gain of 2. Queen moving to his left. Has a receiver and a nice catch as number 24, DJ Render, goes flat out and extends himself to make the catch.
Got a penalty down here on North Gwinnett's sideline. Wonder if you got another sideline infraction. But you got something over here.
The penalty is against the Bulldogs. And I think that's an illegal substitution or too many men on the field. Or it could be at ease if you're in the military. I'm sorry, I don't know that signal.
Yeah, I believe that's the sideline infraction for him because I saw the side judge over here
look
at the sideline as soon as he threw the penalty.
Either way, it's positive for the Warriors. They're now first and 10 at the North Gwinnett 43-yard line. Lots of jumping around, and another flag comes out.
They're going to call it on North Cobb.
Illegal procedure. Wow. Well, you know, there's a lot of jumping around by the Bulldogs, kind of enticing them into that illegal procedure.
Right,
and I thought that was against the rules.
Right, and I thought they would call that on them, but they didn't, and they ended up calling it on North Cobb.
Backs it up to the 47-yard line. Check that, 48. First and 15 for Tyler Queen and the Warriors. Quick ride receiver screen on the left side, complete to Render again. A gain of about 4 on the play. As we approach the 7-minute mark of the fourth period.
Still plenty of time for this North Cobb offense. 7 minutes, like Randall just mentioned. Long way to go for this ball game is over, but you got to remember, it's an 8-point lead, so whatever happens, North Cobb is probably going to have to go for 2, as they're already used to doing, as they've done it already to get to 21.
Ball is at the 45-yard line of North Gwinnett. It's second and 12 for the Warriors. On the ground and up the middle to Perryman. Check that to Elijah Harrison. He gets it down to the 41-yard line.
Big third down. Looks like this game has been living on third down. The big plays have happened on third down. This one probably won't be any different.
Third and 8. Back to the air. Queen moving around to his right. Going downfield. He's got a man. Caught. Touchdown. Billy Nichols. Warriors are cutting into the Bulldogs' lead after a 38-yard touchdown toss.
What a play. What a throw. Once again, Tyler Quinn used his legs to evade.
We've got a Warrior player down on the field, and we've got a flag on the far side right around the 25-yard line. Tyler Quinn just indicated that referee Mike Boyd let him know it's on the defense. Indeed it is, holding against the Bulldogs. But that, again, was a play that was made by Tyler Queen. He's big, he's thick, but he's very mobile. He's a lot like Roethlisberger, DJ.
He is. He buys times, very elusive. Finds a way to make a play, and he does it. He's done it time and time again tonight. He's done a good job. And number 54, Zach Winstead right there, you see the right guard walking off on his own power, which is good.
So it's a 2-point ball game, and you got to believe that Shane Queen, head coach of North Cobb, is going to go for 2 right here.
Absolutely.
To try and tie it up. 6 minutes, 15 seconds remains in the fourth period.
6 minutes is almost eternity for these two offenses. Anything can happen in the next 6 minutes.
Beautiful 38-yard TD toss from Tyler Queen to Billy Nichols, and now Mike Boyd has signaled timeout called by the Warriors. Which means they will have no timeouts left if that indeed was called by North Cobb.
Not sure if they wanted that timeout.
I'm not either.
It seemed
like they were coming back onto the field.
Right.
Yeah. Nope. He said, okay, Mike Boyd is correcting himself, it looks like. He's saying, come back out and let's get ready for play. So I think it looks like North Cobb will not be charged with a timeout. So they come back out on the field, as does the Bulldog defense. And now we get ready for a two-point conversion from the Warriors.
You gotta wonder down here at the bottom, Jordan McCray, 6'6 receiver, sing it up by himself.
Queen joined in the backfield by Hairston and Perryman, who is to his rear.
He has a real tight split. Usually receivers don't have that tight split.
Big rush, Queen gets rid of it and caught. Caught by number 21, C.J. Cole. The two-point conversion is good for North Cobb, and we've got a tie football game at 29 apiece. What an outstanding way to start our season-long coverage of Friday Night Football from the Channel 2 Sports Zone on WSBTV.com, presented by the Georgia Lottery. These ants coming in.
I know, they all over there.
Yep. After a 12-play, 99-yard drive, and a two-point conversion, North Cobb head coach Shane Queen and his Warriors have tied the second-ranked team in the state, the Bulldogs of North Gwinnett, and they've done it as the road team, and that's impressive, DJ Shockley.
96 and 99, I mean, this team has fought back. Been down by 16. This team has not given up, and that's a reflection of their head coach.
Will Horton handles the kicking duties for the team in white and orange. The North Gwinnett receivers are backing up, thinking no more pooch kick, and they were correct. However, this one fielded at the 12-yard line by number 21, Ryan Lovelace. He gets it out close to the 30.
All right, here's where the game is going to be won and lost still. A lot of time, 6 minutes to go, but a lot of stuff going on here. 6 minutes to go. John Azura coming back. Can he be the guy to take him to another big win?
Here is the touchdown play from Tyler Queen to Billy Nichols.
Loon receiver, and look at the touch. We've talked about the touch all night. Laid it in perfectly, in behind the defense.
First down and 10. Pass complete to Josh Imator Bebe as he gets it out to the 45-yard line of North Gwinnett.
That's a good tackle in open field. Tackling a good receiver like Imator Bebe.
We're at the 6-minute mark. a 15-yard pickup by the Bulldogs. Fresh set of downs as we move under 6 minutes. John Urzua, the quarterback for the team in gray. Cameron Pickett joining him in the Bulldog backfield. Plenty of time for Urzua. Now finally chased out of the pocket and taken down by Rashawn DeCastro, a senior defensive end. 5'10", 190 pounds, but still a pretty good scramble by Urzua.
Yeah, that was one of those good coverage on the back end, maybe a cover, not a sack, but a good coverage tackle. Defensive backs played a good job covering receivers down the field.
A positive play of 4 yards for the Urzua and the Bulldogs. Oh, and he gets nailed from the backside by Brandon Bennett, the outside linebacker on the blitz, and that one stung.
Yeah, the senior comes away with a big sack coming off the outside linebacker. John never saw him.
A loss of 7 yards on the play. Makes it 3rd and 13 for the Bulldogs. Going from their own 42-yard line. Little screen out of the backfield, complete to Cameron Pickett, but nice play by 45, and a little bit too much chatter by Cale Reed afterwards. He's lucky he didn't get flagged for unsportsmanlike conduct.
Well, look at here. Look what's happened. Look what North Cobb has seized the momentum of this football game. Defense gets a 3-and-out, plays lights out on that drive, forcing a punt. We're going to have the ball with a little bit less than 4 minutes on the clock for Tyler Queen to make a dramatic finish to this ball game.
Brad Harvey is the North Gwinnett punter. Gets it away. North Cobb return man will let it fall, and it'll be downed at the 18-yard line of North Cobb. But the last time their offense was on the field, they put together a 12-play, 99-yard drive. So this line of scrimmage,
it's nothing.
Is nothing for them.
299 and 96-yard return. Look at Tyler Queen as he walks onto the field. He has to walk like, I'm finna go win this football game.
This would be a huge upset, ladies and gentlemen. North Gwinnett, ranked number 2 in Class 6A in the state of Georgia. Fresh off a huge victory over number 1 McEachern a week ago. And now North Cobb looking to upset the Bulldogs as Queen bobbles the first down snap and will be dropped for a loss by number 91. That's Dixon Yalot.
Yeah, as that ball hit the ground, it was doomed from the beginning, and it's just a good job of getting back on it.
Loss of 3 on the play will result in 2nd and 13 for North Cobb. Queen, quick release. Wide receiver screen, DJ Render, the receiver. Good run after the catch for number 24 as he picks up a first down for the Warriors.
Good job of Render getting outside his blocking, setting it up. Good job of getting outside as well and just pitch and catch here. This is what they've done all night. Get the ball in open space. Tyler lets his players make plays.
Pickup of 16 yards on that play. Gets it out to the 30-yard line. Fresh set of downs for the visitors in white and orange. Oh, all kinds of room for Perryman. And finally taken down deep in the backfield by Ollie Edwards. But Perryman picks up 17 on that first down run.
Wow, North Cobb found something in the run game they haven't had all night long. Gashes here and there. They're going to run this clock all the way down. Here's the replay. Good job of pulling, cutting off the backside, and there's the hole. Good open to the tackle, but not after a long carry.
Another completion to DJ Render. Gets it out close to midfield, but a flag comes out. Less than 3 to go. Tie ball game and a very costly holding penalty against North Cobb. They were marching. This slows them down.
That probably was the last thing they wanted with the clock and also with how they're moving the football right now. A holding call that's going to set them back 1st and 20. But, hey, they've overcome it already. So it's
Nothing new to them.
They've been overcoming obstacles all night long.
Absolutely.
Very impressive display by the Warriors of North Cobb. Backs up the line of scrimmage to the 38-yard line. It'll be first and 19. First and 20. Little screen pass to Perryman, looking for running room, and look at his second effort, getting it out to midfield. A great play by Perryman after the catch.
Nice play call. It always seems like North Cobb has a screen play dialed up whenever North Gwinnett's blitzing. That time it worked out and was able to pick up positive yards.
Gain of 12 yards on the play. It'll be second and 7. The ball is at midfield. Queen didn't like what he saw when he tried to release it. Double clutched it, threw it into the dirt. Now a 3rd and 7 for the Warriors.
Sometimes that happens. Sometimes that's all right just to throw it in the ground. You don't want to give up a big play or turnover or some type of penalty.
This is going to be a huge play. The North Gwinnett faithful rising to their feet here at Tom Robinson Field, doing what they can to cheer on their Bulldog defense. 3rd and 7 for the Warriors of North Cobb. Extra pass rushers. Queen avoids it, finds a drop down secondary receiver in Jordan McCray, and he picks up the first down. And what a huge play by Queen, once again extending the play for a gain of 18.
And that's been the MO all night long for Tyler. Every time they get in trouble, and especially on third down, he uses his legs to buy some more time, and no defensive backs can ever be able to hold up for that long. He finds an opening guy.
Especially with a receiver like Jordan McCray, 6'6", 170 pounds.
Yeah, he's come up big tonight for him. Big third down conversions for him all night long.
Less than 2 minutes to go, and the Warriors are marching. 1st and 10 at the Bulldog 32-yard line. Referees, get out of the way. We want to watch football, not you guys. Let's go. First and 10. Keeping it on the ground up the middle of the Perryman. Breaks inside the 15-yard line and gets it down to the 12-yard line. And the Warriors, with a minute 44 seconds to go, are in the red zone after a gain of 20 yards.
Oh, look at this. This is just 1-2. Running through arm tackles. 1-2-3. Another arm tackle. Trying to strip it out. Perryman has been the guy in the second half when they needed a big run.
Everybody really on North Cobb has been outstanding in the second half. Think about how tough and discouraging it was for the Warriors in the first half as the Bulldogs pulled off trick play after trick play, and now they have a chance to take the lead.
And here's the interesting thing. It's a minute 24. North Gwinnett can do nothing about the clock.
No timeouts left. Queen on the move. Quarterback draw, going for the corner, looking to stay alive, but finally taken down at the ankles by Ollie Edwards, the senior defensive back for the Bulldogs.
And look at Tyler feeling it, pumping his chest. He's feeling it right now. He can feel a win for North Cobb coming in right now.
And looking over there to that North Cobb sideline and all their students and families cheering them on, they can smell an upset. A minute 10 remaining in this contest.
Man, who's going to have the ball? Huh? Tyler, who's going to have the football?
With the line of scrimmage at the 2-yard line, you know number 15 in white is going to have it as he looks over to his dad and they try to milk as much clock as possible. Queen keeping it himself, going for it up the middle, denied the first time. Looks like he'll be stopped shy of the end zone at the 1-yard line. Now a timeout is called or signaled by referee Mike Boyd. But remember, okay, we had it wrong. North Gwinnett had one timeout left, and they've used up their final timeout. 45 seconds remain in regulation. And I say regulation because right now we're tied at 29.
That ball's sitting right on the 1-yard line. You have a quarterback that is 230 pounds. He's already scored a couple times tonight off. Quarterback draws, QB sneaks.
I do not expect this ball to be anybody else's hand but Tyler Queen. Even if it's not a run, they're going to give him a run pass option somehow, some way, because he's made excellent decisions whenever he's had the ball in his hands, running or throwing.
Robert Andrews, the defensive coordinator for the Bulldogs, with final instructions for his defense. And Tyler Queen, the Auburn commit, first team All-State a couple of years ago, coming off a discouraging performance in week one, has been nothing short of a stud tonight here at North Gwinnett High School. He keeps it himself, looking for the end zone. Elford grabbed him at the waist, and everybody else came on and denied Queen. The clock stops with 38 seconds left. North Cobb calls timeout.
Wow. Wow. This is the fight you want out of North Gwinnett. Giving up some big plays, getting down here, but just because they got in the red zone or inside the 1 yard line, don't mean you have to concede the touchdown. These guys are fighting tough down here, and Coach Andrews is getting the most out of this defense right now. You got to think they got to try something else if you're North Cobb to get him on the corner. They got to find another way because they're keying on him, especially running up the middle.
Exactly. Everybody is ganging up to stop number 15 and White. So like you said a few moments ago, give Queen a run play option if you're North Cobb so he can drop it over that wall of defenders.
Yeah. Our fellow buddy Zach Klein loves the naked bootleg. I'm sure he would be calling for the naked bootleg right
sure.
now.
I'm not sure Queen quite has the speed for the corner. But who knows?
We'll see. Big third down right here.
Huge third down. Third and goal. 38 seconds remain. We're tied at 29. North Cobb in white and orange trying to knock off the number two ranked 6A team in the state of Georgia. Queen barking instructions. Queen walks into the end zone. Touchdown North Cobb with 34 seconds on the game clock.
Wow, what an amazing finish to this football game. Queen showing the Superman, showing he was going to go down and take his team to the promised land, and he's done that, taking the lead down by 16 at one time. Now to have the lead, wow.
What an impressive display in this second half and especially this fourth quarter for the visitors from North Cobb. Will Horton on for the PAT. The snap and hold are good, and so is the kick. So with 35 seconds remaining on the game clock, the visitors take a 36-29 lead on the second-ranked Bulldogs of North Gwinnett. Stick and stay for the final 35 seconds here on WSBTV.com. Dude, what a game! I love it! The stunned Bulldogs of North Gwinnett. They have pulled off so many dramatic victories in the last few years of high school football, but now they've got a huge obstacle to overcome, trailing by 7 with just 35 seconds remaining. Will Horton Kicking it off for the Warriors of North Cobb. Fielded inside the 10 by the Bulldogs. Number 27, Jordan Frye breaks out, finally taken down by the kicker, Horton, just shy of the 40-yard line.
Oh, that was almost a house call. That got Davis for a second. But what that does is it gives North Gwinnett a good field position with 28 seconds left. They got to take a couple shots down the field. They got to take some chunk yardage.
Line of scrimmage will be at the 40-yard line of North Gwinnett. John Urzua with Weddington in the backfield with him.
Got to remember, John Urzua had a game-winning drive last week. A little bit more time, but this one, 28 seconds. Can the senior come through with some heroics?
He tossed the game-winning TD toss a week ago with 9 seconds left on the clock. Quick release by Urzua. There's the hook and ladder. Oh, my goodness, to Weddington. Successfully executed, except Weddington slipped when he got the football.
How did we not know that was coming? Shame on us not knowing coach was going to call the hook and ladder.
They're setting the chains. He picked up the first down just past midfield. North Gwinnett already lined up as referee Mike Boyd winds the clock, but now timeout called by North Cobb. That's their final timeout of the game, and a good timeout used by their head coach, Shane Queen. You're right, DJ. How would we not know?
It's a good timeout, but I don't know how good it is because you're giving Coach Bob Spire a chance to look through that playbook and find one he hasn't used yet. Oh, wow.
Look at this.
He's got a chance.
Hook and ladder for a second straight week, and Weddington slipped.
You got to time this out just right. Look if he gets it out. Oh, man, look how much more yardage he had in front of him. He had at least another 10 yards in front of him.
And he could have gotten out of bounds. So 17 seconds remain on the clock. Don't ever count out the Bulldogs of Bob Spire. Line of scrimmage is just past midfield. No timeouts for either football team. The visitors leading by 7. Here comes Urzua and the Bulldogs. Urzua, another hook and ladder, but this one not executed. It was intended for Josh Amator Bebe, but a flag comes out at the end of the play. That's a fumble, actually. It was caught by Knutson. He tried the hook and ladder this time on the left side. Amator Bebe dropped the ball, so that's a fumble, DJ.
They can run a hook and ladder from any formation, any way possible. Amator Bebe comes from the other side. He's the inside receiver. They run the curl.
Oh.
I'm not even sure if he had that ball all the way.
If Knutson, the receiver, had the ball, or Amator Bebe?
Amator Bebe never really had the football.
The flag is on North Cobb, so that's more free yardage.
That sets him up for more. This is
unbelievable. The referees mark off the penalty, and it will move the line of scrimmage all the way down to the 20-yard line. And now, with 9 seconds to go, Urzua can throw it into the end zone. No timeouts for either team. North Gwinnett trailing by 7, but they have the football at the North Cobb 20-yard line. Here we go. Plenty of time. Urzua scrambling around. This will be the final play of the game. Urzua throwing it up for grabs, but it's out of bounds and it falls incomplete. And North Cobb comes into Sewanee, Georgia, and knocks off the second-ranked Bulldogs of North Gwinnett thanks to a dramatic fourth quarter. They rally from 16 down, and they stun the Bulldogs of North Gwinnett.
Wow, what a ending for North Cobb.
Holy cow.
This is everything and more that you asked for on the first night of high school football.
What a game for week one of our season-long coverage of Georgia high school football here on WSBTV.com. We'll be back right after this to wrap up this fantastic game. Right.
Got it.
The Warriors of North Cobb continue to celebrate a huge victory for their program and their head coach, Shane Queen, as they rally from 16 points down in the second half and win it on the road here at North Gwinnett High School. Well, DJ Shockley, we had a few blowouts a year ago. I like the way this season has started.
Oh, it started with a bang. It started with a bang. It is very interesting. I'm glad we were here tonight to witness this. It was an amazing game. Both sides fought really well, but North Cobb comes out on the winning end.
You really got to give a lot of credit to the visiting Warriors. Their quarterback, Tyler Cream, their head coach, Shane Queen. I mean, the father and son combo and all the great plays converted by the North Cobb offense and some great plays made on defense as well, and they really stunned the Bulldogs.
They did. North Gwinnett tried to come out and do some trickery in the first half, not much of it in the second half. In the second half for North Cobb, it was all ground and pound. Used the legs of Tyler Queen to extend plays and make some touchdowns. He did that. Big passes. The senior committed to Auburn came through with some big plays.
Let's show you how this upset was pulled off by the Warriors. DJ just finished talking about Tyler Queen. Look at him stand so tall in the pocket, but that was his early mistake, the interception by Parker Seacrest of North Gwinnett, as Queen stuck him right at the end of that play. Now from there, the Bulldogs went on and continued to manage the momentum as their Cameron Pickett rolled over and just stomped one of their would-be tacklers into the ground. And at that point, DJ, the Bulldogs had full control of the game.
Yeah, they did. And this is where you see North Cobb again and start to take over. Big runs, big catches on the outside. Quanti Green there making a play after the catch. And it was a great job of them getting some momentum going into the second half right here. Big play.
72-yard scoring play that time for Quanti Green completing it. And then Tyler Queen found Billy Nichols behind the coverage. Beautiful touchdown toss from Queen to Nichols, and that's when the Warriors started believing.
Yeah, you can feel the momentum starting to change here. And Tyler said, I'm going to put this game on my shoulders, and that's the two-point conversion there to tie it up at 29. And obviously they would get the ball back. And the end of the game right here, the big touchdown, buying time. We talked about with his legs, extending plays. That was a huge third down play and catch by Jordan McCurry.
Absolutely. That extended the drive for the Warriors. Then they handed off to Perryman. He took it up the middle and got it down into the red zone of the Bulldogs. And then Queen looking for the corner, denied right at the end. Now, after this play, the Bulldog defense stuffed Queen on a couple of plays, but then a little play action. He pulled it out of his running back's belly, and he took it in himself, and that led to the game winner and the final score of 36-29. As impressive as North Gwinnett can be, that makes this victory for North Cobb that much sweeter and also impressive.
Absolutely. You think about what North Gwinnett did last week versus number one McEachern, upsetting them in the big classic game. And then North Cobb comes into North Gwinnett and takes a big win from a very good program. You got to give Coach Queen and his whole coaching staff and players a huge pat on the back for the night, the way they came out, being down by 1.16 and then be able to come out and finish this game and get a W.
What a great win for North Cobb there. First of the season. You remember they opened with an 18-point loss to Northside Warner Robins a week ago. And, oh, my goodness, you can't have much of a bigger comeback from a loss than to knock off number two North Gwinnett on their own home field. For DJ Shockley and producer-director Stephen Lawler, I'm Van Earl Wright, thanking our entire hard-working crew and thanking you so much for joining us on this week one of our season-long coverage of Georgia high school football on WSBTV.com, presented by the Georgia Lottery. Once again, our final score, North Cobb 36, North Gwinnett 29. We'll see you next week right here on WSBTV.com.